great ball games, great moments on NBC.
Happy New Year, everybody. I'm Bob Costas in New York, and again, NBC presents a New Year's Day triple header. It begins with the Fiesta Bowl, Michigan against Nebraska, then out to the granddaddy of them all in Pasadena as Iowa tries to snap the Pac-10's recent domination of the Rose Bowl game going against UCLA. And once more, it appears that the best game of all is the Orange Bowl. It winds it up tonight on NBC. The national championship likely to be decided. Penn State ranked number one, but the Oklahoma Sooners favored against the Nittany Lions. Let's get it started as we go to Tempe, Arizona.
The sixth-ranked Cornhuskers of Nebraska. Going against the fifth-ranked Wolverines of Michigan. This is Fiesta Bowl 50. Today, Nebraska with a 9-2 record against Michigan with a record of 9-1-1 from Sun Devil Stadium in Tempe, Arizona. And what a gorgeous afternoon we have for this confrontation to kick off 1986. The two head coaches on the left, that is Tom Osborne, and the right, Bo Schembecker. Ironically, two of the greatest college coaches in the country. They have never competed against each other, never coached against each other. They're both looking forward to this game. Nebraska won the toss. They deferred the choice to the second half. So that means that Michigan has the choice. They'll be receiving. Dale Klein will be kicking off for Nebraska. The two return men for the Wolverines, number 23, Jamie Morris, and number 40, John Colazar. Hello, everybody. Happy New Year. This is Charlie Jones along with Sam Ratigliano. And Sam, this is the makings of a great football game.
Well, no question about it. We have a great Michigan defense and the leading rushing team on offense in the nation in Nebraska.
And we're underway. It'll be Jamie Morris, and he'll down it 2 yards deep. So Michigan will go to work at their own 20-yard line. And let's look at the offensive set for the Wolverines. The quarterback is number four, Jim Harbaugh, the number one quarterback in passing efficiency in Division 1A. Gerald White, Jamie Morris, they're the running backs. Paul Jokic, John Colazar, the tight end is Eric Kattis. A lot of offensive weapons. Elliott, Vitale, Tabachino, Husar, and Miller, that offensive line for Michigan. In motion, and the give is to Jamie Morris, and Morris pops it for a first down. 12 yards to the 32. Brian Siebler makes the tackle. And let's look at that Cornhusker defense with Tucker, Spockman, Noonan, Scow, and Reeves. That's the defensive line. The linebackers are Knox and Parsons. And in the secondary, you've got Brian Davis, Dennis Watkins, Brian Washington, and Chris Carr. And here's Morris again to the 37-yard line. Gain of five. It'll be second down and five as Kevin Parsons, the weak side linebacker, brings him down. Let's take a look at Jamie Morris, 5'7", 175-pound sophomore.
Watch Jamie Morris with Gerald White as the lead back. Now watch his vision now. He cuts to the right, ran a first down for 12 yards in the first play, and it looks like Michigan right now is going to run the ball to start.
And, of course, you know that Jamie's older brother, Joe, with the New York Giants and against the 49ers, rushed for 141 yards. And that is the goal of Jamie Morris today. And here's the fullback, Gerald White. White just a couple of yards to the 39. So it's third down and three as Greg Reeves, the defensive right end for Nebraska, was there to bring him down.
Tackle by number 84, Greg Reeves, and number 44, Mike Knott.
Bo Schimbeckler.
Third and three on the Michigan
Molding
39.
The number two defensive collegiate team in the nation. And there's something to watch on defense as well as offense. Third down and three. Harbaugh to throw. Has pressure. Dives to the 44 and he'll have the first down. He got 5 yards.
Jim Harbaugh,
the senior out of Palo Alto, California.
Jim Harbaugh is a very resourceful quarterback. He drops back now. He's looking to throw for a first down. Comes back to the inside. Now he's going to tuck the ball down. He's aware of where the first down marker is. Now he's just going to hook slide for a first down. And this is going to be a problem for Nebraska's defense all afternoon to keep him contained.
Play action on first down. Has pressure over the middle. Incomplete. Going to Eric Cattis. His tight end cannot pull it down at a second down and 10.
Covering on the play, number 44, Mike Knott.
That's Bob Tabaccino, 77, 95, Dan Noon. He comes off one block, and 74, John Vitale, Mike Cusar picks him up, and he was double-teamed in the middle. Dan Noonan has had 11 sacks this year for Nebraska.
And we'll be taking a lot of look at that offensive and defensive line play, both when Michigan has the ball and Nebraska has the ball. The draw, Jamie Morris, the Cornhuskers right there. A loss of three to the 41, so it's third down and 13, and that means that Harbaugh will be throwing. Jim Scow, the All-America defensive tackle for Nebraska, making the tackle. Harbaugh has had a hot hand at the end of the regular season. The last three games of the season, he completed 41 of 50 passes. That's 82%, 706 yards, 9 touchdowns, and no interceptions. That's the good news. The bad news is that was 5.5 weeks ago. So the timing is not going to be there like it was then. Let's see what he can do. You know he's going to throw third down 13. He's got pressure, throws into coverage, and is incomplete. Colazar, the intended receiver, so it is fourth down and 13 as Brian Washington was there for Nebraska.
Jim Harbaugh is trying to throw for first down. He's looking to his left. There's John Colazar running a hook pattern, but the ball's a little too high, and Dennis Watkins comes in from the high behind as the right corner for Nebraska.
So Monty Robbins will be kicking. He has a 40-yard average. Ryan Siebler and Rob Schnitzler are set for the return. There is no wind here in the first half. A fair catch is called for by Schnitzler, and he takes it at the 19-yard line. A 41-yard kick, and Nebraska will be going on offense for the first time. When we come back, we have no score in the Fiesta Bowl. The 1986 Fiesta Bowl is brought to you by Miller Beer. Miller made the American way since 1855. By Ford, who invites you to drive the new Ford Taurus. Have you driven a Ford lately? And by IBM. The sun is shining in Tempe, Arizona. No score in the Fiesta Bowl. Nebraska on offense for the first time. From their own 19-yard line, McCathern Clayton is the quarterback, but you'd look for the give to Doug DeBose. As the Cornhuskers, offensively, they will rush 79% of the time. Billy Harris, the middle guard, making the tackle. He simply don't put the ball in the air that often. And as is Clayton, the quarterback, DeBose and Rathman, the fullback, he's a good one. Schnitzler, Lindstrom, and Frame. That line, Roth, Blankenship, Lewis, McCormick, and Welter. Second down and 7. And Rathman gets the call. Andy Moeller was there for the Michigan defense. And let's take a look at that defense. Mr. Harris and Mike Hammerstein, and he's a great one, the All-American at defensive tackle. Scarcelli, Moeller, Mallory, and Akers, the four linebackers. Rivers, Cochran, Hicks, and Gant in the secondary. That's the basic set. Third down and 5. And Nebraska shows a power eye formation at third down and 5 as Shepard is in. And the keep is the quarterback, Clayton. 28-yard line. He's going to come up about a yard shy of the first down. Let's see where they're going to spot the ball. They'll mark it at the 28, so it'll be fourth down and 1. And that means that Wingard will come in to kick. Let's take another look.
This is their third down. This is a finesse part of the game. They're coming out right now. Lewis is blocking on Billy Harris. That's Bill Lewis, number 68, one of four All-Americans at center. And that's where they're going to be running all day long in their power game behind Lewis.
Flags are down. There is pressure. Eric Campbell steps away from it, and it takes a Nebraska roll inside the 15, inside the 10, all the way to the 6-yard line. But there was a flag back at the 30. If it stands, it's a 66-yard kick. But the players are all turning and coming back. David Arnold was putting the pressure on the punter, almost got there. Offsides against Michigan. It was fourth down and 1. And so Nebraska will retain possession. They'll have a first down.
Those are the type of mistakes that I'm sure Coach Schembecker does not want his team to make. Now they're going to give the ball back to Nebraska.
So Nebraska at their own 33-yard line, first down. Ken Kalen is now the fullback for the Cornhuskers, number 49, the junior from Westerville, Nebraska. Number 22, the I-back, Doug Dubose, bothered by a shoulder injury, but he is starting and he is carrying to the 37. So he adds 4 to the total. It'll be second down and 6. This is Mike Mallory, one of the captains of the Wolverines, was there to make the stop.
That was an interesting formation. They took Todd Frayne and moved him to the left, and they were in an unbalanced line, and they ran the pitch to DeBose. There's no question that Coach Osborne wants to run the power game, and that is get the ball to the tailback and the fullback. But it's going to be a great test for the Michigan defense.
Rod Smith comes in, the receiver. Von Shepard comes in. And Michigan was waiting for the ball. Mike Hammerstein, number 66. A loss of 3.
I talked to the defensive coordinator of Michigan, Gary Moeller, yesterday, and he did not feel that the Michigan defense could sit there against that power game. And so you're going to see a lot of stunting today by their linemen. And Hammerstein came in there untouched and met DeBose right at the exchange.
Third down and 9. Kalen is the remaining back. This is a passing formation for Clayton. He goes with the quarterback draw. We'll pick up 5 to the 39. It'll be fourth down and 4 as Billy Harris and Mark Messner were both there for the Wolverines.
It's very obvious, Charlie, that Nebraska now is going to have to throw the ball. There's Mike Hammerstein to the outside, and it's a designed quarterback draw on the part of Clayton, the quarterback. But Osborne is going to have to go to the passing game. He is not going to be able to run over this Michigan defense all day long.
Wingard kicking to Eric Campbell. Remember a moment ago when he had a 66-yarder. It came back with a penalty. Another good kick. Campbell circles, takes it at the 8-yard line, and has 3 yards on the return to the 11. A punt of 53 yards. Paul Miles was there for Nebraska. We've got a timeout, and we have no score in the 1986 Fiesta Bowl.
Lynch family.
Sam, Nebraska does not like to throw the ball, but they may have to today.
Well, no question about it. They're obviously tried the power game, and they tried the finesse game with the option by the quarterback. They're going to have to throw the ball on first down and run downs because Michigan's defense is ready right now to stop that power game.
Oh, it is a great defense that we'll be watching today. Michigan has the ball at their own 16-yard line. There was a 5-yard penalty against Nebraska. The return was to the 11. And we have no score. As Michigan goes to work for the second time offensively in the ballgame. And they open up with a play action fake. Harbaugh throw. The pass is complete to Canis. A big gain to the 36-yard line. 20 yards on the play. Ryan Siebler, defensive safety for Nebraska, makes the stop at the 36. First down. 7 minutes and 52 seconds left to go. First quarter is another look, Sam.
Watch the play action now by Harbaugh. He's looking for his tight end across. And there's the tight end, Eric Caddis, who has caught 35 passes this year. And now they're in good field position.
Jamie Morris and Gerald White are the running backs. And here's Morris. 42-yard line. He picks up six. It'll be second down and four. So the Michigan offense comes out. They're cranked up. Steve Force, weak side linebacker, replacing Kevin Parsons, makes the tackle. Jamie Morris, three brothers played at Syracuse. Larry, who plays in Canada. Clint, the sprinter. And Joe, who we mentioned, with the New York Giants. And Jamie is only a sophomore. Rushed for 874 yards this year, a 5-yard average. And here's Gerald White. White to the 47-yard line. So he'll pick up four, maybe five. Let's see where they spot the ball. They may mark it at the 46. And Kevin Parsons was there.
This is one of the differences in the game right now, that Jim Harbaugh, the quarterback, is going to mix the run and the pass, and Clayton, the quarterback for Nebraska, is going to have to do that. This could be a key factor as to who controls this football game.
It was second and four. They did get 5 yards. It's a first down for Michigan at their own 47. No score in the ballgame. Here's Jamie Morris. But this time, Nebraska's All-America Jim Scow from Omaha, with 15 sacks and 25 tackles for a loss, was there for the defense.
What a matchup we have between Jim Scow and Clay Miller. And there's John Vitale. Jim Scow comes off the block and tackles Jamie Morris in the backfield. He's an All-American, but he disengaged the block and got to the ball carrier. That's what you look for in a good defensive lineman.
Second down and 11 after the loss of a yard. Harbaugh to throw. It is high as receiver fell down. Kolazar making the cut at the Nebraska 40-yard line, slipped and fell. And it'll be third down and 11. Kolazar, the fastest man on the team. His father, William, played for Michigan in 1953, 54, and 55. Kolazar, only a freshman out of Westlake, Ohio.
And the last game against Ohio State, he broke the game wide open with a 77-yard touchdown pass from Jim Harbaugh.
Harbaugh completing only one of four in the early going for 20 yards. Here's the draw. And Jamie Morris, first down, 33-yard line of Nebraska, a gain of 21 yards. Ryan Siebler finally stopped him.
They're doing it from the I formation. Looks like a pass, and there's Jamie Morris on a draw play. Gets excellent blocking. Now he works his way back to the outside. Now he's looking for the first down marker, and he gets a good block by 84 Paul Jovich, which gave him the first down. And there's Jamie Morris on the sideline.
First down at the 33-yard line. Bob Perryman comes in to spell him. And this is Kolazar in motion, number 40. And the give is to Gerald White, who moves to tailback. And he goes to the 28-yard line. He'll pick up five before Kevin Parsons brings him down. Second down and five. Michigan starting this drive back at their own 16-yard line. And we have no score with just under 5.5 minutes to go. We're in the first quarter of the 15th Fiesta Bowl. And we've got an official's timeout taken on the field.
Bo Schembechler said that Gerald White was a very diversified type of back. And to take him in the drive as the lead back at fullback, which does most of the blocking in the I formation, and then move him to tailback in the same drive, gives you the kind of flexibility that really helps your offense.
So Bob Perryman is the fullback, and Gerald White the tailback. Harbaugh the quarterback. And here's White. White to the 26. He has a couple. It'll be third down and three as the middle guard for the Nebraska Cornhuskers, Danny Noonan from Lincoln, Nebraska, made the stop at the 26.
And Charlie, John Colasar is out there one-on-one with Dennis Watkins, and he has the wide open out pattern. If he were to throw to the wide field to John Colasar, he'd have a first down and possibly a touchdown.
Colasar goes wide to the far side. Eric Caddis, the tight end, is on the same side. And Jokic splits away to the near side. Third down, three. And the give is to Perryman. Perryman on the quick opener to the 25-yard line. The defense was there, and he will be shy of the first down.
Scott Tucker,
number 89, was there, and that means that on fourth down, Pat Moons will come in with a field goal attempt. He has hit two out of three, and that was in the Ohio State game from 34 yards and 38 yards out. This will be an attempt of 42 yards. Moons, a senior, with his first action in the last game of the season against Ohio State. And he hits here. Pat Moons opens the scoring with a 42-yard field goal. Michigan out in front, 3-0. Pat Moons just opened the scoring for the Michigan Wolverines. 42 yards on the field goal. The record, by the way, is Luis Zendejas' 54-yarder. But right now, it is Michigan 3, Nebraska nothing. And kicking off will be Rip Sutkiewicz, the sophomore from Troy, Michigan. And the deep backs are Keith Jones and Paul Miles. Jones, number 6, end zone Jones, and Paul Miles, number 21. And Miles will take it at the 6-yard line. And he almost breaks it to the 26, 20 yards on the return, just a step away.
Tackle by number 41.
And Todd Schulte, the linebacker, were not there. 17. He would have broke this for a touchdown. Paul Miles.
When you think of Michigan and you think of Nebraska, you always think of the All-Americans. Bill Lewis, Jim Scow for the Cornhuskers. Mike Hammerstein, Brad Cochran for Michigan. Just joining the long, long line of All-Americans from both schools. Nebraska trailing 3-0. First down at their own 26-yard line. Doug Mallory defensively bringing down Tom Rathman, the fullback, at the 32-yard line. A gain of 6, so it's second down and 4. Rathman at 6 feet, even 220 pounds, a senior from Grand Island, Nebraska. All Big 8, but if they had fullbacks for All-Americans, Osborne Fields, Coach Tom Osborne Fields, he would be an All-America fullback because he does the things that a fullback should do.
7 big runs, 1 84-yard run for a touchdown.
Here's DuBose. DuBose to the 35, little stutter step to the 40, a stiff arm, goes out of bounds at the 43-yard line. He picks up 11 and the first down. Tony Gant chases him out.
What's happening now? Nebraska was going inside, and Michigan was doing a good job. Now they pitch outside, and there's DuBose on the sideline, and number 14, Tony Gant, makes the tackle. What they're doing right now is trying to change their attack and get the ball outside. They want to go into power game, but they've got to loosen up. Here they go into an unbalanced line again.
And mark it for a gain of 12 to the 44. A flag is down. The pitch is bobbled. DuBose never had a hand on it. There was a scramble for it as Mallory was there. Messler was there for Michigan.
The ball was already down.
Clayton, the quarterback, may have already been down when he made the first pitch.
Now, here's the option. Clayton now is going to try to get the ball out to DuBose. And that was an ill-advised toss because they dodged the bullet right here. Messler almost picks up this fumble. Michigan's defense is really penetrating and is going to cause a lot of problems for Nebraska. Nebraska has the defense.
Still first down.
Has tried to get the ball outside, but get involved in the deceptive game. Get back into the play action game. They've got to loosen up that Michigan defense.
So Nebraska got away with one there. Michigan also offsides down, goes over first down and five. Ball moves out to the 49-yard line. Michigan leads 3-0. First quarter, 2 minutes and 40 seconds left to go in the first. Ball carrier is Tom Rathman. And he goes to the Michigan 47, so that's a gain of four. And it's going to be second down and about one as Jim Scarcelli and Doug Mallory, who is in as a strong safety replacing Ivan Hicks, are there to make the stop. Second down and one. Schnitzler comes back in, as does Roger Lindstrom on a second and one. Even though Nebraska runs the ball 80% of the time, second down and one. Is this where you gamble and throw the ball?
This would be a good opportunity for them to get involved in the deceptive. They're going unbalanced line, which means they're going to pitch to DeBose.
We had Michigan into the neutral zone. We had one of the Cornhuskers jumping. We had whistles. And there may have been a 25-second violation.
Charlie, Michigan right now has three defensive backs in the game. Andre McIntyre, number 54, came into the
Dead
game.
Ball. Nope.
Delay of game.
On the offense.
That was a delay of game. Go ahead.
Second down and six from the Nebraska 47-yard line.
Second down and six.
Mallory is back in the game, but they had five linebackers in the game to stop the run.
Clayton, a little play action. Throws. He completes the pass to Todd Frey. First down for Nebraska. 16 yards. Garland Rivers and Tony Gant make the tackle.
And it's something, as we said earlier, they have to do to open up the defense. Now watch the play action pass. McCarthy fakes the ball, comes back on a bootleg. He's got plenty of room. He's looking for his tight end. His tight end's wide open. And the reason he's wide open is because there are too many people on the Michigan defense committed to the line of scrimmage to stop the run. And Nebraska is going to have to do this more often.
The play goes to the Michigan 37-yard line. First down. Mike Reinhold checks into the defense. Here's Bond Shepherd. Shepherd to the 29-yard line. He picks up eight. It'll be second down and two. And Garland Rivers brings him down.
Von Shepherd is the big play wingback. They were lined up in a power eye formation. Now watch him come back to the right. Gets a handoff. Gets two good blocks. Bounces to the outside. And they're going to have a second down and 2 yards.
Second and two at the Michigan 29. Nebraska started this drive back at their 26-yard line. And here's DeBose. He'll have three. And should pick up the first down. It was second down and two. Doug Mallory was there. Along with the outside linebacker, Jeff Akers. Officials timeout. They want to bring the chains in. I think he's got it, though.
I think he's got it. It's going to be close. But the big difference in this drive is Nebraska now has gone to their finesse game, which means they're going to run the option with Clayton. But the big thing is they're going to the play-action pass game.
It is a first down.
First down.
Interesting, though, as strong a defensive team as Michigan is, and they are one of the best ones. They built their defensive reputation in the Big Ten where everybody was throwing the ball this year. And Nebraska, known for running the ball, but to be successful, they're going to have to throw the ball. It's almost a dichotomy.
Right, but they're going to have to throw the ball off the run fakes.
And here's the quarterback, McCathern Clayton. Garland Rivers stops him at the 18-yard line. And it'll be second down and two as he picks up eight. Mike Mallory was also there.
Nebraska's offense now has control of the game. They're doing all three things. Power the ball, get involved in the option game, and get involved in something they do very well, the play-action pass game.
Second down and two. Here's DuBose with a little pitch. Slips the tackle, turns it on. Down the sidelines, out of bounds. Tony Gant saved the touchdown at the 5-yard line. A gain of 13, first down, goal to go, Cornhuskers. And And with that play, the first quarter comes to an end. Time has run out in the first quarter with Nebraska at the 5-yard line of Michigan. Let's go back to the last play of the first quarter.
This is what Michigan's defensive coach is worried about, is people missing tackles. And right there, Garland Rivers missed the Bose, and now Tony Gant knocks him out of bounds.
We talked about the Michigan defense. They allowed only five touchdowns this past season, two rushing and three passing.
And you can rest assured right now, Nebraska is going to go to the power game. And there's Gary Moeller, the defensive coordinator, on the sideline. I talked to him yesterday about the Nebraska offense, and he worried about people missing tackles.
And his son Andy, number 49, there he is, inside linebacker. 5-yard line, first down, goal to go. Rathbun is nailed. Fullback may lose a yard. And it was Mark Messner waiting for him. Number 60. Woo.
They were involved in the power game. They brought number 54, Andre McIntyre. Now watch him blitz right in the hole. Whoops! Right there. He hits and sticks Tom Rathman right in the hole. And they were lucky they didn't have a fumble on that exchange.
Rathman comes out. Kalen replaces him. Second down goal to go at the set. They're going to throw. Has a man wide open. Pass is complete. Touchdown to the ball. And Nebraska takes the lead.
Dale Klein will attempt the point after.
And who would have thought they would have done it through the air?
And that's exactly why it was a touchdown, because Michigan was geared to stop the power run. And there's the extra point. Now it's 7-3.
Dale Klein splits the uprights. We've got 14:22 left to go in the first half. Nebraska leads by four, 7-3. For Doug DuBose, that is his first touchdown receiving in his collegiate career.
And they're going to have to do that, and I've said over and over, in order to get back to their power game. And that play took 10 plays, and they were able to diversify it by getting the ball to DuBose and passing the ball.
And Bose last season only had 5 receptions for 65 yards.
Well, I think Tom Osborne realizes right now he's not going to be able to run against that Michigan defense.
So Dale Klein will be kicking off for Nebraska. Jamie Morris and John Colazar, the deep backs for the Wolverines. I'm a bit surprised that Nebraska's first score comes through the air, because they are a rushing team. 79% of their yardage rushing during the season. Jamie Morris and John Colazar set for the return. And it is Morris at the 4-yard line to the 15, 20. And returns to the 24, so he'll have 20 yards on the return, and we'll take a timeout with the score, Nebraska 7, Michigan 3, as Brad Smith makes the tackle for the Cornhuskers.
Run back of 20 yards on the kickoff. 899-73.
14 minutes, 17 seconds left to go in the second quarter. It's Nebraska 7, Michigan 3 in Fiesta Bowl 15 as we start off 1986. And then from here, it's on to the Rose Bowl and then the Orange Bowl. We've got flags down. We may have had jumping in contact by Nebraska because Jim Harbaugh, the quarterback, was stepping back and pointing as if accusing the Cornhusker defense. In the Rose Bowl today, Iowa and UCLA. Dick Enberg and Merlin Olsen are there along with Bill McAtee. And here's the call from the referee, Jack Baker.
Dead ball, encroachment on the defense. First down.
And encroachment moving across the neutral zone, making contact prior to the ball being snapped. Down goes over. It'll be first down and 5 at the 28-yard line. Jamie Morris. and he'll lean to about the 31. They'll give him two or three on the play, so it'll be second down. As Danny Noonan makes the stop for Nebraska. After the Rose Bowl, the granddaddy of them all, NBC Sports, moving on to Miami and the Orange Bowl. It's the battle for number one. Penn State against Oklahoma. Don Crickey, Bob Trumpy, Bob Greasy, Jimmy Cephalo, all there to cover it for you. Second down and two. Two tight ends for Michigan. And here's Harbaugh throwing, and it is pulled down. The reason that it is pulled down is that Paul Jokic is 6'8". Almost every other wide receiver would have been overthrown.
Check that number, 84.
Paul Jokic, a former basketball player, is 6'8", but he can run. Now watch him come off his break. Now watch him go up for the ball and makes the catch. And we're Michigan's going to have to do more of that this afternoon, particularly to Jokic, because he's drawing the one-on-one, and he has a mismatch on Brian Washington, number five.
First down, Wolverines at their own 45-yard line. Kolasar wide to the far side. And here's Jamie Morris. And Morris will pick up just a yard to the 46, second down and nine. Also joining our telecast on the sideline, basking in the sun, is Gary Gerald. Gary?
On the Nebraska sideline, Charlie, two quick notes. On the first series for the Cornhuskers, the big fullback, Rathman, had an equipment problem. He was not on the backfield, wasn't blocking. He was there for that touchdown drive. Also, Doug DeBose, we checked with the trainer, that shoulder problem they were concerned about that he bruised a couple of days before this ball game is reacting just fine. No problems at all. Nebraska, of course, in the lead.
Thank you, Gary. Work on your tan, because it's a gorgeous day here at the Fiesta Bowl. Second down and nine. Here's the pitch. Jamie Moore. They'll mark the ball at the 46-yard line. Brian Davis finally wrestled Jamie Morris down. Morris, 5'7", 175 pounds. He said, not only can I hide behind the offensive lineman, in one ball game I hid behind one of the officials. The defender came and tackled the official.
Now here's Jamie Morris with a good lead block by 22, Gerald White. Finds the opening, bounces to the outside, causes a miss right here. Now watch him stay on balance, and now they come up with a very key third down and less than a yard to go.
Paul Schmerge comes in as a second tight end. Third down and one. The give is to the first back, and it's Gerald White. The defense meets him right at the line of scrimmage. He needed a yard. He may have gotten him. Danny Noonan leading the charge for Nebraska. He may not have made it.
It's going to be tight, and it will be a key call for Bo Schembechler. I don't believe they have it, Charlie. It looks like it's going to be less than the football, and Bo Schembechler is going to go for it, and I think it's a good call.
Michigan in their 11th straight bowl appearance. That's the good news. The bad news is his bowl record. Bo Schembechler's record, 2-8 out of the last 11. Gerald White and Bob Perryman are the two running backs. Short yardage, fourth down, maybe a foot. Harbaugh, the quarterback, sneaks it. Nebraska says we held it. Let's see where they mark it. The Nebraska offense is coming out on the field. That's confidence.
Ball carrier, but Jim
Scow and Danny Noonan were there at the bottom of the stack for Nebraska.
And there's Bo Schembechler waiting for an official to spot
official
the ball.
For a measurement.
And a key call at this stage of the game.
And they're going to bring the chains out on this one.
Can you believe you sit over there as a coach right now, both Tom Osborne and Bo Schembechler, and worried about someone placing that ball properly? And now here comes the chains. Here come the chains right now.
I don't think they got it.
Tough call for Bo. It's great if you make it.
They didn't.
But you didn't make it.
Nebraska holds, maybe 4 inches shy, as Michigan gambles on fourth down and a foot. And Danny Noonan is injured on the play.
See, watch the quarterback right now as he reaches out. And you can see right now he's throwing the ball to number 72, the Michigan offensive lineman, John Elliott, which was kind of dangerous.
So Nebraska takes over on downs, but Danny Noonan, the middle guard for Nebraska, was held from the field. He was shaken up on that. Gary Gerald's on the Nebraska sideline. He'll be chasing that story down for us in just a moment. As Nebraska will have a first down on their own 45-yard line, the Cornhuskers leading the Wolverines 7-3 with 11 minutes and 22 seconds left to go in the first half. The temperature in the low 70s. And Tom Osborne having to shade his eyes from the sun. Keith Jones is the eye back, and here he comes. He can fly if he has some room. He doesn't get the room as the Michigan defense shuts him down. Andy Moeller was there at the 46. Gain of a yard, second down and nine. Keith Jones, the fastest Nebraska player in history, number six.
Watch Tom Rathman, the best blocking fullback, makes an outstanding block on Billy Harris, number 56, but that pursuing Michigan defense holds it just to a one-yard gain.
There's DeBose on the sideline. He's just catching his breath. I'll let Keith Jones. Little play action fake to Jones. And then Clayton was going to scramble with the ball, and he slipped and fell. So he'll lose three to the 43. It'll be third down and 12. And on third down and 12, Lindstrom will come in. And Snitzler will come in.
And this is not Nebraska's game. Third down, try to get the ball upfield deep vertically is not their ball game. And if Michigan can stop them, well, they can dodge that bullet on that fourth down gamble.
Lindstrom to the far side, Snitzler to the near side. On the delay, a reverse as Keith Jones does not fool anybody, particularly Mark Messner, just waiting in the wings. He'll lose a yard. It'll be fourth down, 13.
And that's why at times on offense, you can gamble if you have a great defense.
So go back to the fourth down gamble. It did not hurt Michigan.
No. When you have a great defense, you can do things like that because your defense is going to cover for you.
Nebraska ready to go very quickly. Wingert, as the Michigan return team was a little slow coming onto the field. And Eric Campbell is set for the return. Pretty good kick. Fair catch taken at the 20-yard line. So Michigan will take over at their own 20-yard line. A 38-yard kick, just under 9.5 minutes to go in the first half. And Nebraska leads it 7-3. This 1986 Fiesta Bowl is brought to you by Hertz, the number one way to rent a car. By Team Xerox, the right products and right people all working together. And by Kemper and the independent insurance agents who represent us. For all of your insurance needs, ride with Kemper. 9:26 time remaining in the first half. This is Charlie Jones, Sam Ratigliano, Fiesta Bowl 15. Then it's the Rose Bowl and on to the Orange Bowl in Miami. So stay with us on NBC as we open the year. Nebraska 7, Michigan 3. Michigan from their own 20-yard line, first down. And Harbaugh is coming out throwing. Far side. And it is juggled. Is it intercepted? It was Brian Davis going for it. And he just couldn't hang on. Kolasar, the intended receiver. Woo, good defensive play by Brian Davis, whose hometown is here in Phoenix, Arizona.
Exactly right. He went to high school here and junior college. Now watch him sit on the ball. This is the throw. This is the throw. It just didn't get out there fast enough and almost makes the interception. 32 laid back, and then he accelerated on the throw. Now watch him accelerate on the throw, and Kolasar had no chance to make that catch. The quarterback should have gotten the ball there sooner.
Harbaugh has completed only 2 of 6 for 35 yards. Here's the draw. Jamie Morris. And Morris pedals for the first down. 32-yard line. A gain of 12. Kevin Parsons stops him.
Tackled by number 38.
And Jamie Morris now 66 yards and 10 carries.
He's following in his brother Joe's footsteps this weekend. Now it's a draw play off the I formation. Everything's well blocked to the inside. Now watch him bounce to the outside. Does what all good backs do. Eludes tacklers and gets that extra yardage when the blocking is not there.
Jamie Morris this year had 1,329 yards rushing, receiving, and in kickoff returns. That was his total contribution. And here he comes again. Oh, and he is hit at the 30 by Kevin Parsons, but still spins back to the line of scrimmage. It'll be second down and 10, and let's go down to Gary Gerald.
Charlie, a quick word from the Nebraska sideline. Danny Noonan has a strained muscle lower left leg. They expect that he will be back in the ballgame. They don't think he'll be out too long.
Thank you, Gary. Of course, Noonan, number 95, the great middle guard for Nebraska. Second down and 10, the Cornhuskers in front of Michigan, 7-3, with 8:19 left to go in the first half. Harbaugh to throw. And it is incomplete over the head of Jamie Morris.
And he was wide open. That would have been a first down throw, and Jamie Morris was covered by a linebacker, and he would have added a lot of yardage on that play. Right now, he's tough to throw to because he's not very tall, but Jim Harbaugh, Charlie, is a little out of sync. He's just not hitting those open receivers.
Third down and 10. Both backs in the block as some pressure steps away. Has more pressure. He's given ground back to the 10. Has two blocks. Now he throws and it is pulled down by Jokic, but it is incomplete on the sideline. Dennis Watkins was there for Nebraska as Harbaugh was chased all over the field. And Jokic stays down as he was really stretched out when he went up for it. Jokic from Birmingham, Michigan. We mentioned earlier, 6'8", 240 pounds. Let's go back to the play.
Now watch the resourcefulness on the part of Harbaugh. He's going to come back. Now watch. He doesn't want to run. He's looking upfield for an open receiver. And there's Paul Jovis. He goes up. What? Dennis Watkins hits him just as he catches the ball, and it's separated, and Jokic is on a sideline. Here we have another shot of it. Now watch him go up, and there's the hit by the corner, and the ball is separated.
It will be fourth down. We have an official's timeout.
That's very difficult because a receiver has 100% concentration on the ball, and that's all he's looking for to make the catch. And when it's thrown high like that and the defensive back comes in and makes that kind of separation, it's what makes it so difficult as a receiver.
And Jokic with one reception already in the ballgame now has a streak of 16 straight games. The leading receiver for the Wolverines with 36 receptions, 666 yards, averaging 18.5.
And there he is now trying to find an open spot on the sideline. He goes up, he gets hit, and the ball is separated. That could have been very close to a first down throw.
Trainer Russ Miller, who came over to work with Jokic. It is fourth down. And Monty Robbins will be kicking for Michigan. Brian Siebler and Rob Stitzler are set for the return.
Monty Robbins.
The big difference in this game at this point is the ineffectiveness of the Michigan quarterback. He is just not on target, missing a lot of open receivers.
Or the effectiveness of the Nebraska defense.
The combination of both, I'm sure.
Stitzler at the 17, 25, 30. 37-yard line. Gerald White brought him down. 50 yards on the kick, a 20-yard return. We've got a timeout. Nebraska has the lead, 7-3.
Ball down on the 37-yard line.
Let's go to Gary Gerald.
Well, Paul, down here on the sidelines, they're attempting Paul Jokic right now, and you can see it's a concern over the region. We've only had a quick word with one of the trainers. They believe that he should be able to go back into the ballgame. Apparently not be hit on the far side of the field.
And Gary, we're getting a little breakup on the mic. This is a replay of what happened as he went high. Boy, he's really stretched out when he was brought down.
Stretched out and got it right in the rib area.
Nebraska now from their own 37-yard line. Here's the pitch to DeBose. To the 40s, that's a tackle. To the 50, down the sideline, bumped out of bounds. Doug DeBose. And it was Tony Gant who finally got him, a gain of 14 yards.
That's a pitch. Mike Hammerstein, it's a pitch off the option. Mike Hammerstein is not going to make that play. There should have been somebody up from the outside to contain the play. And here's the ball knocked out of bounds by Tony Gant, number 14. But their game is changing. They've left the power game, and now they're going to the option game and pitching the ball to the outside.
Von Shepherd is in, and he'll run from the power eye. The line of scrimmage was the 50 is where they marked him out of bounds. And Shepherd is stopped at the 50, so it'll be second down and 10 as Andy Moeller was there. Moeller, the leading tackler for the Michigan Wolverines. It's Nebraska 7, Michigan 3 with 7:16 left to go in the first half. This is the 15th Fiesta Bowl. Happy New Year, everybody, from NBC Sports, the Fiesta, the Rose, and the Orange, all today. Clayton, inside the 45 to the 44. He's got six. It'll be third down and four. Again, it was Mester joined with Jeff Akers.
Tackled by number 60, Mark Mester, and number 33, Jeff Akers.
Bo Jackson, five carries and 16 yards in the first quarter. It's Texas A&M 12 and Auburn 7 in the Cotton Bowl. And here, Nebraska 7, Michigan 3. Third down and four, Nebraska, at the Michigan 44. Clayton to throw. Clayton to run. First down. 33-yard line. He picks up 11 yards on the scramble. Jim Scarcelli was there along with Garland Rivers from Michigan.
And number 13, Garland
Rivers. It's a sprint out pass by Clayton. He's going to his left, can't find a receiver, and this is what a good athlete does at quarterback. The college game is different than the NFL because the defense has to defend 11 players on offense because of the ability of the quarterback to run the football.
Clayton, 30 yards and six carries. Here's the option. He keeps and he goes to the 26-yard line. He picks up seven, second down and three, and that top-ranked rushing offense of the Cornhuskers just shifting gears. Mike Mallory, one of the captains for the Wolverines, makes the tackle. He was a second-team All-America, and his dad, by the way, is the head coach at Indiana.
Unbelievable that Nebraska could rush for 374.3 yards a game, and now they're back into pitching the ball to the outside, to DeBose, and going with the option with the quarterback, Clayton.
Mike Mallory with that last play. His brother, Doug, is also in the game defensively. And here's Rathman. Tom Rathman, the all-Big A fullback. And it is Doug Mallory with the stop, along with Tony Gamm.
Tackled by number 14, Tony Gamm. First down, Nebraska.
Watch Tom Rathman now. He's going on a counter. He breaks two tackles. He's had eight big runs this year for touchdown, and he actually trips because he could have taken that one right for touchdown. Now watch 66, Mike Hammerstein. He's not ready to make the tackle, and he goes right by him unblocked.
And a gain of 15 yards on the play. Nebraska scoring one touchdown in the game, threatening again at his first and 10 at the 11-yard line. We mentioned that because Michigan last season gave up only five touchdowns. And here is Von Shepard on the reverse. And Andy Moeller is there to make the tackle at the nine. A gain of a couple. Second down and eight. Mike Mallory also there.
Nebraska is really involved in a deceptive game. They're running reverses, they're running pitches, they're running options, and after the first two series that they had the ball, they've completely abandoned almost their power game of running the ball up inside.
9-yard line, here's the power eye. And the give is to the first back, Rathman. Tom Rathman is 6 feet even, a 220-pound senior. He averaged 7.5 yards a carry this last year. He picks up six here.
Tom Rathman is going to be given the ball in the I formation. Everybody's looking for everyone to go deep. And there he goes again. He breaks a tackle. He could have been tackled in the backfield. Again, Gary Moeller, the coordinator of Michigan, was worried about this with those two big backs breaking Michigan tacklers.
Garland Rivers makes the last stop. Here's DuBois. Reaches for the end zone. Does he make it? The ball has to break the plane. And it does. DuBose has now scored, receiving and rushing. And Nebraska leads 13-3 with the extra point to come. The point after. The Cornhuskers out in front, 14-3. Back with the kickoff.
Kicking for the Cornhuskers, number one, Dale
Watch
Clark.
Brian Blankenship, number 70. He puts a hat right on number 60, and DeBose right there goes in, reaches across the goal line for the touchdown. You can see the signal, and we may right now with Doug DeBose be showcasing the 1986 Heisman Trophy winner.
Deep for the Wolverines.
Two touchdowns in the Fiesta Bowl, one receiving his career first, the second rushing, and of course, Vinny Testaverde of Miami, Lorenzo White of Michigan State, Doug DeBose of Nebraska. Those could be the top three. There'll be others, but those have to be considered. Morris and Kolasar set to return the kickoff of Dale Klein. And it'll be down in the end zone.
In the end zone by number 23, Jamie Morris.
So Michigan will bring the ball out to the 20-yard line first down, and the Wolverines are going to have to open up a multiple offense because maybe the surprise has been the Nebraska defense.
The Nebraska defense has played very well, but Jim Harbaugh has missed a lot of open receivers. They've got to throw the ball now more on first down and 10. Get into a good flow, get this quarterback back into sync, and move the ball offensively. They've got to get it to their outside receivers and the tight end, Eric Caddis.
We did say that Nebraska likes to run the ball. Well, they've had 28 offensive plays. They have run the ball 26 times. They have thrown two passes. Fumble on the exchange, and Harbaugh dives for it. Has it at the 19th. So it'll be second down and 11.
Covered his own fumble. Down on the 18-yard line. It'll be 2nd and 12.
Nebraska with a 74-yard drive in 10 plays and a 69-yard drive in 9 plays.
And Paul Jokic is back in the game.
Harbaugh to throw on 2nd and 11. The pass is complete to Eric Caddis, the tight end. 26-yard line, gain of 7, so it'll be 3rd down and 4 as Scott Tucker, the defensive end for Nebraska, made the tackle. Caddis is Michigan's number 2 receiver. Jokic with 36 receptions. Caddis, the tight end, with 35 receptions. The good average, 15 and a half yards per catch. Third down and 4, so Harbaugh will be throwing again. Flag is down. The pass is complete to Caddis. He's got the first down at the 36 if it stands up.
Number 81, Eric Caddis. Brought down by number 5, Brian.
That is his third reception if it holds.
Please report to the South End Zone Command Post.
Nebraska offsides. They'll take the play. It'll be a first down at the 36-yard line. Goes for a gain of 10. Bo Schembechler, if there's a better tight end in America than Eric Caddis, I'd like to see him. Caddis, 6'6", 223-pound senior.
Penalties declined. First down.
And since Bo has become a passing coach, he knows about tight ends that can catch the ball.
Here's a whole new world out there, isn't it? First down, Michigan at their own 36-yard line. Nebraska leading 14-3 with 2.5 minutes to go in the first half. Here's Jamie Morris. Morris, a couple of yards to the 38. It'll be second down and 8 is Todd Proffitt. The middle guard in, replacing Danny Newton, makes the stop.
They have all their timeouts.
Tony Holloway.
Running down to 2 minutes, they're going to have to put the ball in the air to hopefully get a score before the end of the first half.
Second down and 8 to realize what Nebraska has done in the first half. Michigan led the nation in scoring defense. They allowed only, as an average, 6.8 points a game. 6.8. Nebraska's 14 in the first half. Here's Morris on the screen. 49-yard line. He picks up 11 and the first down. Kevin Parsons and Dennis Watkins with the stop. Gain of 11. First down, Michigan at their own 49.
Ball will be placed down on the 49-yard line. Pickup of 11. First and 10 for the Wolverines.
This is a screen pass. Everybody's upfield. He lays the ball off to Jamie Morris, and his screen is like Novocaine. It takes time to take effect. Gets two pretty good blocks. Get a key first down now, and they're up around midfield. They've got to have an opportunity right now to move the ball and get on the board before the half is over.
Has made the good defensive play for the Cornhuskers.
Brian Davis and number 27, Dennis Washington.
Harbaugh runs a play action pass, but he's going to get some pressure. He feels the pressure and gets the ball up. Now Colasar is going up. Now watch Brian Davis. Good timing, goes in front, and Colasar does an outstanding job of preventing an interception.
Harbaugh in the first half has completed only 5 of 12 for 64 yards. Second down and 10, Michigan at their own 49. 1 minute and 30 seconds, that is the time remaining in the first half. Here in the 15th, Fiesta Bowl with the sun is shining. Second time in this drive, a miscue on the exchange between Tabachino, the center, and Harbaugh. And he recovers at the 48, but it'll be third down and 11.
And he's going to call a timeout.
So Michigan takes a timeout, and that means that we'll join him. We'll be going away, but we'll be back in just a moment. Bo Schembechler, the head coach of the Michigan Wolverines. Their record is 9-1-1, and they trail 14-3. Third down and 11 at their own 48-yard line. We've got whistles and a flag. The penalty against the Wolverines. The quarterback for Michigan, Jim Harbaugh, in the last three games completed 41 of 50 passes, 82%. Here's the call.
Dead ball, illegal procedure on the offense.
So he ended up the season hitting 82% of his passes. Today, less than 50%, 5 of 12 for 64 yards.
And that's the key to Michigan's ineffectiveness offensively in the first half.
Third down and 16, the ball at the 43. With 1:16 left in the first half, Harbaugh being chased. Has three Cornhuskers after him. Slips the tackle. He's back to the 20. Runs into his own player. Lose back to the 21. Clay Miller, the offensive tackle, a first-team academic All-America, All Big Ten. The backer just trying to help out. Harbaugh took a left turn right into him. He loses 22 yards. He did chew up some time on the clock. There's 45, 46 seconds left in the first half.
Now watch Jim Harbaugh. He's going to his left. Nope. He's going to his right. And what he should do right now is throw the ball out of bounds. He's trying to make something happen. And no one can help him right here, right now, because they don't know where he's going. He looks like he's on the highway going in the wrong direction.
Tony Holloway finally got to him.
Ladies and gentlemen, we invite you.
He ran about 10 red lights on that play.
And we've got a timeout. We'll be back.
University of Nebraska.
53 seconds is the time remaining in the first half. It is fourth down and 38 yards to go. Monty Robbins kicking. Brian Siebler and Rob Snitzler, the return man for Nebraska. Siebler lost it in the sun, but it takes a Nebraska bounce. It was touched by Bob Perryman at the Michigan 46 or 47 yard line. So the kick is only good for about 25 yards. They're going to mark it at the Michigan 46 yard line.
Now, Nebraska right now has an opportunity to knock out two first downs. They've got all their timeouts and line up and kick a field goal. They could go in at the half 17-3. I don't think they should sit on the ball.
Now, just a moment ago, when Michigan's offense had the ball, Michigan's defense held their own private meeting on the far side. Now, this is one of the top defenses in the country. They haven't been unable to stop Nebraska in the first half. They need to stop them now. So that's the confrontation here. Clayton on a quarterback draw will have a yard to the 45. It'll be second down and 9, and Nebraska immediately stops the clock. Doug Mallory makes the tackle. 38 seconds. That is the time remaining in the first half. We'll take a timeout. It's Nebraska 14, Michigan 3. This is Charlie Jones, Sam Ratigliano, as we're winding down the first half of the Fiesta Bowl. Happy New Year, everybody, in case you just happen to join us. We've got a good one. Nebraska working on an upset, leading Michigan 14-3. Then it's the Rose Bowl, Iowa and UCLA. The battle for number one at the Orange Bowl tonight in Miami, Penn State, and Oklahoma. All on NBC. A little play action fake. The pass is there. It is Todd Frame, the tight end. He heads for the sideline and stops the clock. He goes out at the 20-yard line, but there was a marker on the play. 25 yards if it holds.
It's a play action pass. He's back on the fake. He's looking to Shepard on his right. He finds Todd Frain, number 80. Now Frain knows he only has one timeout, and he's going to hustle to the sideline to get out of bounds, stop the clock, and have an opportunity for a field goal. But the play is coming back.
10-yard penalty against Nebraska.
Here's the referee, Jack Baker.
Holding on the offense. Still second down.
Second down and 19 as the ball goes back to the Nebraska 45.
That was a three-point play because Todd Frain had run to the 20-yard line, and Nebraska very easily could have kicked a field goal and gone in 17-3. He should find Frain more often. He's only found him three times all year long.
Second and 19. Yeah, Frain, regular season completed, had three receptions for 59. And Clayton runs out of time. He's caught by Mark Messner, who had 11 sacks in the regular season. He's from Heartland, Michigan, and a sophomore, Jeff Akers, also there. The ball back at the 40-yard line, loss of five, so it's now third down and 24, and maybe that meeting that the Michigan defense had on the far sideline has done something. They got away with the pass play on the penalty, but the other plays, Wolverines have pretty well held Nebraska in check as we take the final countdown to the end of the first half. It's an upset in the making. Nebraska 14, Michigan 3, halftime at the Fiesta Bowl in the sunshine. Let's take a look at the official statistics in the first half. First downs are even. Rushing to the Nebraska side, which you figured. Passing to the Michigan side, but the margin 64 yards to 20 yards. Total yards 146 to 126. Passing Nebraska perfect 2 of 2. Not a lot, but very efficient. One for a touchdown. For Michigan, what you were talking about, 5 of 12. No turnovers. Time of possession fairly even.
What's deceiving is the passing yardage on the part of Michigan. It has to be a great deal more in the second half. We see Tom Osborne right now, who's got a 14-3 lead. I believe Michigan in the second half, Charlie, is going to have to get their quarterback settled down and get the ball upfield to their outside receivers and their tight end. One score, they're right back in this football game.
Michigan ended the season on a high note. Nebraska and their defeat of Ohio State. Nebraska ended their season on a low note as they were blown out by Oklahoma. Does that have an effect in a bowl game? It's 5.5 weeks ago.
Well, I think everybody worried about that, but it's 5.5 weeks ago. It's obviously did not have an effect on Nebraska. It should have had an opposite effect on Michigan. It should have been a big plus for them coming into the game. But Bo Schembechler said it best. He's already proven that he can lose in bowl games.
Yeah, that's right.
But you have to win a lot of football games to get here.
To get in as many bowl games as he has been. Now, we've talked about the weather here, and it is gorgeous. The temperature at kickoff time was about 72 degrees. I mean, you can work on your tan today. But in Nebraska and in Michigan, the story is a little bit different. It's quite a bit cooler back there. Here it is in Lincoln, the temperature in the 40s, winds at 5 miles an hour, partly sunny. That also means partly cloudy, of course. Ann Arbor in the 20s, 15 miles an hour wind, and flurries. Fiesta Bowl, it is gorgeous.
What a difference those 52 degrees
yeah.
make.
This is Charlie Jones, Sam Ratigliano. As we start the second half, it is Nebraska 14 and Michigan 3. And, of course, today is Bowl Day on NBC. We started off, as always, here at the Fiesta Bowl where the sun is shining. And I'm sure the sun will continue to shine on Dick Enberg, Merlin Olsen, Bill McAtee. They're at the granddaddy of them all. Right about now, they're... You know, they've been watching the first half, and in the second half, they'll start to get their act together. For the Rose Bowl, Iowa and UCLA, as always, it will be a fun game to watch. And then it's the battle for number one, as we'll travel to Miami and the Orange Bowl. Don Crickey, Bob Trumpy, Bob Greasy, Jimmy Cephalo. They'll be there for Penn State against Oklahoma. And now for an update here, let's go to the sideline and Gary Gerald. Gary?
Well, Charlie, we had an opportunity to take a look as the players came on the field. Jokic, we got a quick word with the trainer from Michigan who had the lower back injury. He got a shot in the ribs. He ran out of the field fluently. They say he'll be back in the ball game. He was not in Michigan's last series. Danny Noonan, the middle guard for Nebraska, who had the strained muscle in the lower leg, also ran on. He appeared to be in excellent shape. We couldn't get confirmation, but earlier they told us he would be back in action. So we'll watch the defensive alignment for the Cornhuskers.
All right, thank you, Gary. There is Jokic. You could, you know, he is 6'8", so he does kind of stand above the crowd, you might say. Now, if you will recall, at the beginning of the game, is that Nebraska won the toss, and they deferred their decision to the second half, which, of course, you can do in college ball. They will now be receiving. Rick Sutkiewicz of Michigan will be kicking off, and the two deep backs for Nebraska on the return are number 6, Keith Jones, and number 21, Paul Miles. Now, normally, Doug DuBose is back with Jones, but he has that shoulder injury. They don't want to take a chance on the kickoff return. And this is the speedster, Keith Jones, from a yard deep in the end zone. Has some daylight. And returns to the 24-yard line. So he has 25 yards on the return. We talk about his speed electronically timed in the 40 at 4.33. And that means he goes, phew. And they say, ooh, is he that fast? He can fly.
And that's why they call him End Zone Jones.
End Zone Jones. Steve Thiebert made the tackle to the bowl records for Nebraska. 13-10 for Michigan, 6-10. And Nebraska goes to work here at the 24-yard line. And the give is to Tom Rathman. And Rathman is stopped by Mark Messner. Messner's brother, Max, played professional ball for Detroit and Pittsburgh. And I'm wondering, you know, the Michigan defense got together on the sideline. Gary Gerald told us, passed that information on to us that we gave you right at the end of the first half. And I'm sure that they got together again at halftime. And you expect to see the real Michigan defense in the second half.
They got together at halftime with the chairman of the board, Coach Schembechler.
Second down and 9, gain of a yard. Lots of time to throw. Has a man up, knocked away. DuBose was wide open, but the defensive play by Mike Mallory. Could have saved a touchdown. Ooh, yes.
Clayton is looking to his right. He can't find the receiver. He refocuses now. He finds the receiver. Now watch Mallory knock the ball down. DuBose was wide open, and had Mallory put up two hands, he could have caught that pass as opposed to knocking it down.
Third down and 9. So you look for Clayton to throw here. Lindstrom in motion, and it's a draw. And DuBose, a fumble. Michigan has it at the 20-yard line. First turnover of the ball game.
It's Michigan's ball.
Jeff Akers was the man at the bottom of the stack scrambling for it. And I thought that he had it. The official is the final call. And that's it. First turnover of the ball game.
It's a draw play, and they allow too much penetration. There's a penetration right there. DuBose gets spun around. He loses the ball. Watch 33, Jeff Akers, make the key recovery. Now, here it is. It's a draw play. Watch him give the ball to DuBose. They get good penetration. Now, that ball is knocked out by number 42, Mike Mallory, and Jeff Akers picks up the fumble recovery. Michigan's ball inside Nebraska's 25-yard line.
And they go with two tight ends, Schmerge and Kattis, at the 21 first down. And Harbaugh Rose wants to throw. And it is incomplete as he overthrows Gerald White. He was just throwing the ball away. Maybe White could get to it, maybe not, but he wanted to make sure that he was not trapped, and he got rid of it. It'll be second down and 10 at the Nebraska 21-yard line. So Harbaugh now 5 of 13 for 64 yards.
It's important right now, Charlie, even if they kick a field goal, they can score a touchdown and a two-point conversion. They can be right back in the ball game with a tie. It's important right now that they get points on the board after this fumble recovery.
And they go with one tight end as Schmerge comes out, and Kolasar comes in as a wide receiver. The give is to Morris. 10, 5, 3, 2-yard line. 19 yards. Kevin Parsons stopped it. First down, goal to go Michigan. Jamie Morris, you know, we talked about possible Heisman Trophy candidate.
Watch the block by Gerald White, number 22, which springs him. John Vitale, 67, turns to the inside. Now watch him go for that goal line and get that extra yardage, and they're inside the 5 with first and goal.
88 yards rushing for Morris. 17 carries. First down, goal to go. And here's Gerald White. To the one, it's second down and goal to go. Perryman coming in for Morris as he comes out for a breather. And Morris is only a sophomore.
He's handing the ball off to Gerald White. Now watch him drive and watch him try to reach out and bring the ball across the goal line, the plane of the goal line. And as you can see, he's very, very short.
Michigan with a double tight end set. Second down, goal to go, 1 yard line. Perryman and White are the two running backs. And it is White. Touchdown, Michigan. White, who had 10 touchdowns during the regular season, scores his first in the Fiesta Bowl. And it is now Nebraska 14, Michigan 9, and Pat Moons, a senior, will attempt the extra point. And it is good. And Michigan pulls within four. We'll be back with the kickoff in just a moment.
Michigan put in a bigger back, Gerald White at the tailback. Now watch the offensive line get a good surge. He goes up over the top, and what you have to do there is your offensive line has got to control the neutral zone, push the defense back as you see it right now. Excellent block. Watch now, number 74, Mike Hussar coming over, blocking Kevin Parsons, 35, and Gerald White going over the top, control the neutral zone, go over the top for a touchdown. And now the score is 14-10 after that fumble.
And the key, the turnover, Jeff Akers recovering the fumble for the Michigan Wolverines. At the 21-yard line, they scored in four plays. So Rick Sutkiewicz, the sophomore from Troy, Michigan, will be kicking off, number seven. With Keith Jones and Paul Miles set for the return for Nebraska. Miles on the near side, Jones on the far side. Miles at the 4 yard line to the 10, 15, has an opening, 25, 30. Good return to the 33 yard line where Paul Smirgy makes the stop. The 1986 Fiesta Bowl is brought to you by Ford, who invites you to drive the new Ford Taurus. Have you driven a Ford lately? By Team Xerox, the right products and right people all working together. And by Light Beer from Miller, everything you always wanted in a beer and less. Nebraska 14, Michigan 10. Nebraska with the ball. First down at their own 33-yard line. 12:50 left to go, third quarter. Another fumble recovered by the Cornhuskers. Von Shepherd fell on the fumble. The miscue between the quarterback Clayton and the handoff to Shepherd.
Von Shepherd is their big play wing back. He runs a lot of reverses. There he is right now, a little disgusted, because had he gotten that football, now watch. Watch the handoff, and there's the exchange right there between the tailback, DuBose, and Shepherd, and they're fortunate right now that he was had enough presence to fall on that fumble. And now the momentum is shifting towards Michigan.
Second and 15. Hicks is back in the secondary for Michigan. Another fumble, and Michigan has it. Moeller and Messner were going for it, and Mark Messner has it. So two turnovers, and Michigan has the ball.
And it proves the Michigan defense, you can score more on defense than you can on offense. The Michigan defense right now has caused two big turnovers in the second half, has turned this game around. Now, Clayton is coming out on the option. He doesn't protect the ball. It gets knocked out, and there is 49 and 60, and 17, Ivan Hicks caused that fumble.
Last three Nebraska offensive plays, two turnovers. The ball at the Nebraska 38-yard line. First down for Michigan. Michigan trails 14-10, and here come the Wolverines.
Reverse.
And it is Paul Jokic striding out at 6'8", and he throws down the sideline. It is incomplete. giant strides by Jokic. He has very good speed, 4-6 speed.
Now, Charlie, Mo Schembechler went to the last page of the playbook to get that one.
I think it wasn't in the playbook. It was stuck against the wall.
Here's the reverse. We got a 6'8" quarterback right now. He's being rushed. He's looked for an open receiver. Nobody's open. Now he just gets rid of the ball, and now you come back 2nd and 10.
And this is Michigan. Can you believe that play? I like it.
Versatility at its best.
That's right. Way to go, Bo.
This is the new Bo Schembechler.
No gain. 2nd down and 10. And here's Jamie Morris. Slips a tackle. Cuts back. 1st down. 20-yard line. Kolasar with a key block. Davis with the stop, 17 yards. Now, Morris has rushed for 105 yards and 14 carries. I started to say this earlier. He's only a sophomore. Look for him as a Heisman Trophy candidate, maybe a year away.
Now watch Morris. Now he gets a good block by his tight end, Kattis. There's a missed tackle. Now watch him upfield. Now watch John Kolasar, number 40. If you block upfield, you get touchdowns instead of first downs. Excellent block by the wide receiver.
20-yard line, 1st down and 10. Kolasar in motion. Gerald White. White to the 5. Dives, did they say? Did he make it? No, they're going to mark, I think, just short. He needed 20 to score. They're going to give him 19. They're going to give him 19 and 2 feet. It'll be 1st down and goal to go, a foot away.
Now watch, Gerald White, number 22, gets very good blocking. Everything is sealed to the inside. Breaks a tackle right there. Now what he's trying to do is stiff arm and get to the end zone. And the official, watch the official right now. He's fighting to try to get to the end zone. It's a good call because he's out of bounds. Give him the ball again from the I formation.
1st down, goal to go. And turned away. Gerald White trying to dive over the right side of the line. Tabachi, Huzard, Miller. And turned back by Brian Davis, who just met him airborne. Woo! And spun him back. He'll lose a yard on the play. Look at this hit.
Now watch the hit. He's going to go airborne. There's Mike Knox, 44, and Brian Davis, number 32. And again, Michigan was not able to control the neutral zone. And 32, Brian Davis, came over the top, made a great play to stop the touchdown.
Perryman and White are the running backs, 2 tight ends. They show motion. And the option, fake of the pitch, Harbaugh dive. Did he make it? Yes. The ball just has to break the play. The official said that he made it. Touchdown, Michigan for Jim Harbaugh. Michigan's 2nd touchdown in 3.5 minutes. And Michigan takes the lead. They led early 3-0. And then they've been trailing, and now they're back in front. The extra point by Pat Moons is good. It is Michigan 17, Nebraska 14. We'll be back with a kickoff.
Here's the option play on 2nd down. Fakes to the back. Now he wants the pitch. He decides not to pitch. Now watch him turn up inside, leap, get the ball across the plane of the goal line, and it's a touchdown. 2 fumbles by Michigan, by Nebraska. 14 points for Michigan. Now they have the lead.
2 turnovers, 2 touchdowns. We're 4 minutes and 17 seconds into the second half. At halftime, just 4:17 ago, it was Nebraska 14, Michigan 3, and now Michigan leads by 3. What did Bo Schembechler say at halftime?
Bo Schembechler said, "Forget what I told the press. I was kidding about my bowl record. I want to win this football game. Don't take them serious."
Or you'll go back home by bus, and you'll be pushing the bus, too. Here we go. Sutkiewicz kicking off. Let's see if Nebraska now can come back. Paul Miles takes it at the 1-yard line. To the 10. Hit at the 15, comes down at the 18-yard line. Now let's go down to Gary Gerald.
Well, Charlie, we're down here behind the Michigan bench, and you're watching in as this offensive unit is talking, and the dramatic change in momentum is just, it's something you can feel everywhere here. The defensive unit was so angry at the end of the first half. Remember, this is a team that gave up less than 7 a game. They've only given up more than 14 twice all year. They were really upset. Their pride was hurt, and it's been in evidence here in this early third quarter.
Here comes Nebraska from the 18-yard line, and here's Doug DuBose. And he will pick up maybe a yard to the 19, so it'll be second down and 9 as Mike Mallory makes the tackle. On the kickoff, the tackle was made by Tim Schulte. Here's the scoring by quarters.
And look at the third quarter.
Past season.
And look at the third quarter. 79 to their opponent's 6, which is, they're on their way for that right now. Of course, they're not going to score 79, I don't think.
But they have scored 14. Here's Clayton to throw. It's there on target. He goes to Todd Frey, the tight end. And Nebraska moves out to the 40-yard line, a gain of 21 yards on the play. And, of course, the first down. Doug Mallory was there for the defense, along with All-America Brad Cochran. Now, Cochran, number 30 for the Michigan Wolverines. You don't really call his number or his name that often because he is so good they stay away from him.
Right, he's a fine prospect. Gil Brandt has said he's an excellent pro prospect in this year's draft.
Nebraska needing now to crank up that offense. First down. A fumble, but the play may have been dead. No, the knee was down is the signal for the referee, Jack Baker. Jeff Akers was there for Michigan. All of a sudden, Nebraska's got fumbleitis.
What's happening right now, they're faking the reverse. Watch them fake the reverse to Shepard, and he's coming out in an option, and there was just too much penetration by 56 Billy Harris, and he fumbled the football, but the ball was called dead. Now they have a second down and long, which is not Nebraska's game offensively.
Second and 14, 3 in the secondary for Michigan, so got extra linebackers waiting for the run. Here's the pitch. And it'll lose a yard as Jim Scarcelli was there.
It was an option. However, there wasn't any option attached. Watch him come right out now and fake. He comes out and he just pitches the ball. Doesn't, well, he's going to option because he had Messner right there. And Jim Scarcelli is waiting. They had a man on the faking back. They had a man on the quarterback. And they had another defender on the option back. Covered it very well defensively.
Third down and 15. Michigan now with 4 in the secondary. They look for the pass, little play action. Pass is complete. The ball comes loose. They're going to say no. They're going to rule it incomplete. Tom Banderas, the intended receiver, and he was shaken up. Doug Mallory was there for Michigan. We have seen a different Michigan defense in the second half than we saw in the first half. Now leading, now they're living up to all of their press credentials, leading the nation scoring defense, giving them only 5 touchdowns in the regular season. Here's the third punt for Dan Wingert, and Eric Campbell is set for the return. Has pressure, it's blocked. David Arnold blocked it. And he has it for Michigan at the 5-yard line of Nebraska.
Who's the punter?
Dan Wingert was the punter, number 15. David Arnold blocked it, and he and Ed Hood were scrambling for it, and they now got it at the 6.
Now watch the receiver from the outside. Now watch him lay out and time it perfectly. Number 15 timed it perfectly, and that's what most punt blockers don't do. They get a little too close to the kicker. Outstanding play by David Arnold.
A freshman from Warren, Ohio. 6-yard line, they mark it. First down, goal to go, Michigan. Jamie Morris and Danny Noonan, who had that injury in the first half, back in the ball game, and he is there for the defense. We'll mark it to the 5. Second down, goal to go. We're moving on the 8-minute mark. Still left 7 minutes into the third quarter, and it's Michigan 17-14. They threaten to have 7 more. Bob Perryman checks into the offense for the Wolverines. So Perryman will be the fullback, and Gerald White will be the tailback, and Smirky comes in as a tight end to join Eric Caddis. 2 tight ends on the set. And here's Gerald White. It'll be third down and goal to go, as you see, Gerald, just about a yard away from the end zone.
It's an important series because they want to get the touchdown as opposed to having to kick the field goal, because that means Nebraska can come back with 1 touchdown, extra point, and they're ahead. Watch for the play-action pass now on third down with Jim Harbaugh coming out with the football.
Brian Davis making the last stop. Here's White, and he is it. And the defense for Nebraska, led by Kevin Parsons. It'll be fourth down and goal to go. Now what do you do? Michigan 17, Nebraska 14. Do you go for the touchdown? He lost a yard, back to the 2. Or do you go for the field goal?
Right now, the way their defense is playing, you go for the field goal. Get up by 6 points.
So Michigan takes a timeout to work on that decision. We'll take a timeout and be back in just a moment. The decision has been made in Pat Moons with a field goal attempt from the 9, an attempt of 19 yards. He is hit from 42 yards out. Monty Robbins, the kicker, is the holder. So they go for 3, and they get it. So even though Michigan moves their total to 20-14, it's a boost for the Nebraska defense because they hold from the 6. They have to settle for a field goal. We'll be back in a moment.
Give me the 3 field position.
6:42 left to go in the third. Sutkiewicz will be kicking off for Michigan, but guess what? For Nebraska, Doug DeBose is back. That is number 6. That's Keith Jones. The other return man is number 22, Doug DeBose. There he is. First time that he has been on the kickoff return team. Normally he's there. Been replaced by Paul Miles because he has a shoulder problem. Sutkiewicz kicking off. And Jones... it ricochets, picks it up at the 10. Stutter step finally returns it to about the 15-yard line. Tim Schulte was there for Michigan. Let's go down to Gary Gerald.
Charlie, we've enjoyed watching Bo Schembechler here in this third quarter. The 2 fumbles forced by the defense, then the blocked punt. I tell you, we know about the intensity of this man, his great collegiate coaching record. He has been thoroughly enjoying this second half. He was beaming ear to ear, a little disappointed they didn't get the touchdown a few moments ago, but that field goal and a 6-point lead has kept the smile in place.
It's Michigan 20, Nebraska 14. Thank you, Gary. And right now, the Cornhuskers need to get something going offensively. McCatherine Clayton, the Nebraska quarterback. Now, the average field position in the third quarter has been, are you ready? The average field position for Nebraska, their own 22. For Michigan, has been the Nebraska 21-yard line. That's due to the turnovers, the blocked punts. Mike Reinhold made the last defensive play, and it's second down and 10. Showing the power eye, the give is to Von Shepherd. Shepherd, maybe a yard, and that's going to be all. It's going to be third down and 9 as Mike Mallory was there to greet him, along with Andy Moeller, the 2 inside linebackers. I don't know what Bo said to that defense at halftime, but it was effective.
Well, he apparently made his point, because right now Michigan's defense has solved all the problems that Nebraska was giving him during the course of the first half. And there's Gary Moeller right now, the defensive coordinator, giving the signal.
Third down and 9. Clayton, there's a flag as he turns upfield. He goes out of bounds. Short of the first down. They're going to mark it about the 23. A flag dropped to the 13.
I think we're going to have a clip on Doug DeBose, number 22.
Six, It is a clip against Nebraska. Steve Thiebert and Andy Moeller were there for the defense.
Now watch Clayton coming to the outside. There's 66, Mike Hammerstein, and he clearly gets clipped by number 22, Doug DeBose.
I think they'll refuse it. Make it fourth down.
No question about it. Let's take the football. That's what they want to do right now. No sense giving him another opportunity to have the ball.
Here's the score in the Cotton Bowl this afternoon. It is Texas A&M 15 and Auburn 13 at halftime. And Bo Jackson, 10 carries, 31 yards, one reception for 73 yards, but two touchdowns. Winger will be kicking. Eric Campbell set for the return for Michigan. 5:26, time remaining. In the third quarter, there was a little pressure shown from the punter's left side. Maybe he thought about that block kick. Not that good a kick, only 30 yards.
And that clearly came about because of the block punt on the previous punt.
We've got a timeout, and Michigan has the lead. David Arnold had another shot at a block kick, but he pulled up. He comes from the top of the screen.
Watch him right now. He should lay out right now. Whoops, he pulls up and stops for a red light. He might have had another block kick.
Nebraska offense.
That's Tom Osborne in a red shirt talking to his offense right now, and he's got to solve some problems that Michigan's defense.
Jamie Morris to the 40, cuts back 30, 26-yard line. 26 yards on the play. Brian Washington with the tackle, first down. Morris now, 16 carries, 133 yards.
I think his brother Joe is enjoying this in New York.
And Joe,
now watch Morris right now. Break tackles. Now, all great backs go back against the grain. And when you go against the grain, that's where the big yardage comes. Another outstanding run. 16 carries, 133 yards. Big, big difference in their offense in the second half.
First down. And here's Morris again. And he's pulled out at the 21-yard line. He'll have five. Second down, five. Chris Carr makes the tackle. Chris Carr and Ryan Sieber alternate at that defensive safety spot for the Cornhuskers. In Sunday's ball game, Jamie Morris's brother Joe for the Giants rushed for 141 yards. And so Jamie is within just a two or three steps of what his brother did. And he comes out as Bob Perryman comes in. And that means that Gerald White will move over to tailback.
They're in a pass formation.
Little play action. Harbaugh rolls. And goes sliding out of bounds. Chased by Neil Smith.
It's important right now not to have a turnover. If they don't make the touchdown, then they can kick a field goal and be up by 9 points, and it then takes two scores on the part of Nebraska to go ahead in this game.
Third down and six at the 22-yard line, and Danny Noonan is back in for Nebraska as their middle guard.
This is a situation where all year long he likes to go to number 81, his tight end, Eric Gattis.
Tom Osborne, who you saw, the 17th consecutive bowl game for Nebraska, their longest, that's the longest streak in the nation. Far side, and it is incomplete. Had to get rid of it too soon. Jokic did not have time to look around, but there was a flag drop back at the 27-yard line. 4 minutes left to go in the third, and Michigan leads it 20-14. And this will go against the Wolverines. That was third down and six.
They might take the penalty because it could push him back into poor field goal position.
I think here that you would take the penalty.
Because right now a field goal means a 9-point lead as opposed to a 6-point lead. Two scores on the part of Nebraska, and they're going to take the penalty. Good decision.
Here's the call.
On the offense, still third down.
Now what Michigan will do here, Charlie, is either run a draw or a screen and try to get half of it to get right back in field goal position. They're not going to try to get the whole, all the yardage at once.
Third down and 16 with Perryman, the fullback, Gerald White, the tailback. The quarterback is Jim Harbaugh. And Harbaugh to throw. And he goes into the corner. And a flag is down on the play. Kolasar, the intended receiver. Dennis Watkins had the coverage, number 27. Defensive pass interference against Dennis Watkins. And that will be a 15-yard penalty from the line of scrimmage.
Now watch it. He lets it go for all the money. Now watch Kolasar and Watkins. Kolasar is going up now for the ball, and Watkins clearly jumps in front of him, makes contact, and it's a good call on the part of the official.
15-yard penalty. Ball's on the 17-yard line. First down.
The penalty takes the ball to the 17-yard line, and it is more important for the Wolverines, a first
Robert
down
Stevens,
at that point.
Sergeant Angel at the Southwest Police Trailer. Robert Stevens.
So Michigan Angel leading 20-14. With Jamie Morris now back in the ballgame. And Morris jumps to the outside and goes to the 3-yard line. 14 yards for Jamie Morris. Chris Carr was there for the defense. And Morris has rushed for 152 yards.
Down on the 3-yard line.
Penalty may cost them seven points. Big backs are in the game now. Wiltshire and Gerald White at tailback.
Two tight ends on the offensive set. And Perryman hit right at the line of scrimmage. Jim Scow is there for Nebraska. Now, Nebraska, earlier in this period, called on inside the 5-yard line, and they turned Michigan away. They did not let them get into the end zone. And they're faced with that same thing here.
Michigan is trying to pound the ball inside. I look right now for a decision on second down to come up with some type of play action or try to run the ball wide. They're not having success running off tackle inside the 5-yard line. Nebraska's defense has done a good job. Another big series for the Nebraska defense.
Two tight ends. Play action fake. Harbaugh has pressure, throws. And pass interference. Yes, good call. Kattis, the intended receiver. And Tony Holloway will have pass interference call on him. It's against Nebraska.
Pass interference charge against the Cornhuskers.
And take the ball to the 2-yard line.
Ball will be placed down on a 2-yard line.
And it is pass interference on Tony Holloway. First down goal to go. Kolasar comes in. Jokic comes out. And Kolasar goes to the right side. He's the flanker. White and Perryman are the running backs. Kolasar in motion. And the Cornhusker defense is there. It'll be second down goal to go, led by Danny Noonan. And tell you, Nebraska's tough inside their 5-yard line.
They've made a lot of big plays inside the 5-yard line. Again, they're back. Another big defensive series. Michigan's coming in with their receivers, and they're probably going to throw the ball on second and third down. Again, a field goal is a very good play for Michigan. They go up by 9 points. They have Jokic now outside on Brad Davis.
Second down, goal to go on the option. Harbaugh leads, he's got it. Harbaugh scores his second touchdown. And Michigan goes up 26-14 over Nebraska. Now, with a score 26-14, don't forget you can go for two in college ball. And Michigan is going to take a timeout. I think that's what they wanted to do, but maybe they got caught or changed their mind, or they want to make sure they got all the right people in. So let's go back to the touchdown.
This is the same play that Jim Harbaugh scored on before. It's an option play. There you see the option back, and he just takes it up to the inside and goes over the plane for a touchdown.
In the second half, Michigan has four possessions. They've scored three touchdowns and one field goal in their four offensive possessions.
And Jim Harbaugh scores his second touchdown on the option play, and Bo Schembechler is feeling a lot better about this football game at this point.
But Michigan now has only one timeout remaining in the game. Nebraska has three timeouts. We've got 1 minute and 53 seconds left to go in the third quarter. And you can paint this second half maize and blue of the Michigan Wolverines and stamp it with a big D for their defense.
Defense recovered the fumbles, blocked punt, and two pass interference penalties against Nebraska gave Michigan all their opportunities for scores in the second half. And I think this is a good choice right now. If they make the two, they go up by two touchdowns, 28-14. Look for some type of play-action pass on the part of Jim Harbaugh, the quarterback. Jokic is out there one-on-one, 6'8" against a 6-foot corner.
Going for two. Flag is down. Jokic pulls it down, but there was a marker. Don't forget the flag. Well, you picked him up. That is a mismatch, isn't it? It is against the Wolverines. Holding Michigan. No 2 points.
They'll kick the extra point now.
So now Pat Moons comes in. The most points that Nebraska has allowed this season was 27, and that was in the game against Oklahoma. Michigan now with 26.
Pat Moons will attempt the extra point. Ball will be held by number 43, Monty Robbins. From the 13-yard line.
Holding on the offense, we're having a little trouble with mic breakup. And so the extra point attempt by Pat Moons, a senior from Fort Lauderdale, Florida. This is a 30-yard extra point attempt. It's not a chip shot anymore from there. And he's got it. And we'll be back with the kickoff after this word from the NCAA. The preceding message was furnished by the Fiesta Bowl Committee and the NCAA. And now with 1 minute and 53 seconds left to go in the third quarter, this is Charlie Jones, Sam Rattigliano with Michigan in front now, 27-14 over Nebraska's Rick Sutkiewicz will kick off to either Doug DeBose or Keith Jones.
Right now, Nebraska is in the worst type of position they want to be in. They're down by two scores, and they have to go to the throwing game. They just can't continue to try to run the ball. They have to go to the play-action game and a drop-back pass. And it's something that they have not done well all year long.
Here's DeBose. And he returns to the 18-yard line. So Nebraska at their own 18-yard line. First down, Jeff Akers makes the tackle. And Carlitos Bostic was also there, number 99. Bostic is always around on the special teams. This half, DeBose with three carries and a minus 4 yards. So Tom Osborne needs to crank up the Cornhuskers. Rathman. And Tom Rathman has the first down as he picks up 12 yards from the 18 to the 30 in the first down. Garland Rivers and Tony Gant make the stop. So maybe Rathman becomes the answer, Sam. You go to your fullback and he can do a little bit of everything.
Watch, they're in a power eye formation. He gives the ball to Rathman. Now watch him cut back. Picks up a key 12 yards, and right now they're going to have to do something else to get back to DuBose, but they have to throw the football to get back in the game.
This time it's the fake to the second back through, and the quarterback keeps fumbles. The ball is loose, and Michigan will have it as Ivan Hicks comes up with a recovery. Hicks has not been playing that much in the ball game. But that is the second time that he has caused a fumble or been involved with a recovery. So even though Hicks, I think he's been at Bo's doghouse. I don't know that for sure, but he hadn't played that much. But he's made a couple of big plays for the Wolverines.
And there's the hit again, and Mike Mallory, 42, is involved. Now there's a big scramble, and Hicks now comes up with his second fumble recovery. A surprise change at the beginning of the game. He played only one play, Ivan Hicks, and Doug Mallory came in the game. But he has shown his presence by recovering two fumbles.
Michigan at their own 49-yard line, first down, leading 27-14. And Harbaugh comes out throwing as pressure steps away. It is tipped. It is caught by Jamie Morris, and Morris will end up losing a yard. Kevin Parsons was there for Nebraska, and it'll be second down and 11.
We have a play action pass now. Watch Jim Harbaugh avoid the rush, and now Jamie Morris comes up with the interception. I'm surely that's not in the playbook to be done that way, but now we're in a second down and 11.
So the reception for Jamie Morris, second down and 11 at the 48-yard line. And here's Morris. To the Nebraska 47-yard line, Mike Knox was there for the Cornhuskers. So a gain of five. It's going to be third down and about six. Michigan's last four possessions, touchdown, touchdown, field goal, touchdown.
And all as a result of mistakes and miscues on the part of Nebraska.
Possibly caused by the Michigan defense and their special teams. Always the other side, Sam.
Right. There's always a cause and effect.
That's right.
For every action, there's a reaction.
And we're taking the countdown now to the end of the third quarter. So three are in the books, one to go at the Fiesta Bowl. And it's 27-14 Michigan. Steve Taylor, the freshman from Spring Valley, California, quarterback for Nebraska, the other quarterback, because Travis Turner with a knee injury. Travis, by the way, is here on the sideline on crutches. And Steve Taylor is loosening up. And there's Travis Turner in the dark glass. He was even out during warm-ups holding for snaps. And
situation being what it is right now, they need a drop back quarterback in the game to get the ball upfield and overcome this deficit.
Third down and six. And a flag is down as Jamie Morris just works his way back to the line of scrimmage. That's about it. Kevin Parsons was there, and as you take a look at the flag and the penalty, let's go down to Gary Gerald.
Well, Charlie, a quick report on the Nebraska sideline. On that previous series, just before the fumble, Rathman, the fullback, carried the ball for a big gain. He got about 12, but he also took a pretty good blow on the head. He came off on the sidelines a little oblate. The head trainer, George Sullivan, had some ice and some towels on the back of the neck. He thinks that he'll probably get back in the ballgame set. However, he really did get his bell rung.
All right, thanks for the report, Gary. And we're glad that you're here, by the way, coming in from Sacramento. You've been fighting a lot of fog recently. Through three quarters, here's a look at the statistics. But let me add one more number that's not there. Michigan had the ball in the third quarter, 11 minutes and 1 second.
And scored 24 points.
Yes.
Those are the two keys.
Yes, that's right. Monty Robbins is kicking, and Rob Schnitzler set for the return for Nebraska. Not that good a kick, but gets a pretty good roll. Hey, it's going to turn out all right for Michigan. It'll be down at the one-yard line. Andy Borowski, the snapper, was down. It'll go in the books as a 46-yard kick. We'll be back in a moment.
Mike Kemmerstein down the ball.
The 1986 Fiesta Bowl is brought to you by Ford and your local Ford dealer. Have you driven a Ford lately? By light beer from Miller, everything you always wanted in a beer and less. And by John Hancock Financial Services, meeting today's needs with a range of financial products. Happy New Year, everybody. This is Charlie Jones, Sam Ratigliano, and Gary Gerald at Fiesta Bowl 15, 14-25. Left to go in the game. Michigan out in front, 27-14. As Doug DeVos of the Cornhuskers carries from the 3 to the 5-yard line. Gain of 2, it will be second down and 8. And Billy Harris, the middle guard for Michigan, along with Mark Messner, was there. Oh, they're going to mark the gain out to the 6-yard line, so it'll be second down and 7. And Doug Mallory is into the defense for Michigan, replacing Ivan Hicks. Hicks has really not that played that much, but when he's been in there, he's made some big plays. Second down. The give is to Tom Rathman. You got the report on Rathman that the bell was ringing. Well, he may have picked up a yard, so it'll be, let's call it second down, let's call it third down and 6, as Mark Messner was there. And there is Tom Osborne. What a program that he has continued at Nebraska. This year, the record 9-2, one of the outstanding coaches in the, and interesting with it, with both of the coaches, he and Bo Schembechler. Between them, they have a total of 7 bypasses. It's a tough profession, coaching. Osborne has a triple, and Schembechler has a quadruple. Here's the pass to Todd Frame.
And that's his third reception, which equals the amount of receptions he's made in every game this year.
That's right. During the season of the irregular 11 games, Frain had 3 receptions for 59 yards. Mallory and Cochran were there for Michigan.
Now watch Clayton on a play action. It's a bootleg. He gets rid of the ball just in time, gets it to Todd Frain, and now they're out of the soup, and they've got a key first down because that was an important series for Nebraska. Watch Hammerstein, 66. He's right on top of Clayton, but Clayton, again, is a good athlete, and he was able to get the ball off.
And a change at quarterback. Taylor is now in at quarterback. He gives to DeVos, and DeVos goes for the 17 to the 30-yard line. Back-to-back big play, first downs for Nebraska. That's what they need. Brad Cochran makes the tackle, the All-America cornerback.
Now there's Steve Taylor, the young quarterback. What he needs right now is to make sure he thinks about first downs, not big downs. Just get a number of first downs, because if they can get up on the board before 2 or 3 minutes goes by here right now, they're right back in the game.
Steve Taylor, 18 years of age, freshman, Spring Valley, California, regular season, completed only 3 of 6, no touchdowns, 1 interception. And he rolls out with it. Keeps his feet. 46-yard line of Michigan. 25 yards on the play. Mike Mallory with the tackle. And so the Cornhuskers come alive now with 12:22 left to go in the game.
There's plenty of time left in the game. What it is a bootleg, but he definitely decided to run the football. Now he's got good ability, excellent block on number 13, Garland Rivers, and now they're across the 50-yard line. Got another key first down.
46-yard line of Michigan. And now the Wolverines have 5 in the secondary. They look for Taylor to throw. He's going to throw. Far side has a man wide open on a comeback sliding catch. That is Rod Smith, the sophomore from Thornton, California. Mark it at the 38-yard line. It'll be second down and a couple. Rod Smith, 8 receptions, 121 yards in the regular season. The leading receiver for Nebraska was Rob Schnitzler with 16 receptions during the regular season. They don't throw the ball that much. And Du Bois is met right at the line of scrimmage.
Ball carriers, number 22.
Mike Messner was there.
They're going to have a third down, and right now for Nebraska, although they're fighting to score, the biggest thing they're fighting is that clock with less than 12 minutes to go. As a matter of fact, it's 11:13 right now. They've got to pick up this first down, and they've got to go in and score a touchdown. A field goal is not going to be good for Nebraska at this point in the game.
Third down and 2, trailing 27-14. They're in 4-down range, no question about it. And now Michigan expects them to run. They show 3 in the secondary. And here it is. First down to the 31-yard line, Steve Taylor. Gain of 7 and a first down for Nebraska as they start their comeback. And remember, Michigan has only one timeout remaining, and Nebraska has 3.
Also, remember that Michigan had a 2-point play that was taken away from them, and the score right now could be 28-14, which means if Nebraska scores 2 touchdowns, they go ahead.
Von Shepherd gets the call, number 2. And he has 3 yards to the 28, and it'll be second down and 7. Doug Mallory of DeKalb, Illinois, makes the tackle.
I think you have to give a lot of credit to that young freshman, Steve Taylor, to come into a postseason game with down 27-14, and he's moving Nebraska right now, the possibility of a score.
Don't get upset in DeKalb, Illinois. I mispronounced it. I'm 0 for 2. Here we go. On the pitch, it is fumbled, and then scooped out of bounds. And now what the key was Roger Lindstrom. Now, Lindstrom was about 4 yards in front of the fumble and laid a block on a Michigan player who could have, might have, recovered the fumble. That was Garland Rivers.
Now, watch still. It's a reverse option, and it's a very good pitch. DuBose does not handle it very well, and fortunately for him, he gets it, but Lindstrom blocked the possibility of a defender on Michigan recovering it
for the Wolverine.
Possession, for the Wolverine's possession.
And Dieter Heron was the Wolverine diving at it and came up behind it. And now, all of a sudden, Nebraska says, we've got 3 timeouts. Let's take one of them here. 9:57 left to go in the ball game. We've got a timeout, and we'll be back in a moment. It's a Fiesta Bowl record. Today's attendance, 72,454 and 72 degrees. Third down and 7. First down. Steve Taylor, 18 years of age, just a freshman. Mike Mallory makes the tackle at the 19 along with Andy Moeller. He has 41 yards rushing already and 3 carries.
They had DuBose flanked out to his right. That's where he's looking. Now watch him right now come uncovered. Again, a good athlete at quarterback. He's able to run for the first down. It was third down and 7. Big, big play for him right now. They got a first down inside the 20.
The pitch is to Shepherd.
Number 2, Von
5 yards to the 14, second down and 5. Mike Mallory with the tackle. Do you want to use a pitch down that close? I mean the ball's out in the air. They do it all the time. Doesn't seem to bother them.
Well, to an option quarterback, it's just like a drop back quarterback. They practice that all the time. It's part of their offense, and they have to be able to do it in any circumstances.
Here's the power eye for the Cornhuskers. Steve Taylor, the quarterback. A mix-up as he was going to hand off to Tom Rathman.
Ball carried by number 11.
Did he turn the wrong way?
He turned the wrong way, and apparently that's the first mistake that young quarterback made. Now watch him turn. Apparently he should have gone the other way. He had problems with the exchange. He runs into Rathman, and fortunately for Nebraska, he just goes down, and they did not have a fumble, and now they're back to another key third down play.
Third down and 5.
Although at this point, they're in a 4 down area. There's no way in the world they're going to kick a field goal with less than 9 minutes to play.
Little play action fake. There's pressure. He throws in zone. Incomplete. Tom Banderas, the intended receiver, Banderas was trying to get an interference call in the end zone, but I think the interference came after the ball was
there. Took a great deal of athletic ability for him to get the ball off. Now watch it very close. Both Garland Rivers and Tom Banderas were going up for the ball. Now look at Tom Osborne right now. He wants an interference call. The score is 27-14, and you have to identify with the coach on the sideline. He needed that badly.
Andy Moeller putting the pressure on the quarterback. I think it was a good call, or a good non-call. It was not pass interference. Fourth down and 5. Little play action fake. He rolls out. Then he got whistles. Flag was dropped way on the other side, the 4-yard line. Maybe a delay of 25 seconds.
Delay of game charged against the Cornhuskers.
That's what it's going to be.
It'll
be a 4th down and 10. The ball will move back out to the 19-yard line.
The Michigan 19-yard line.
And what we go back to, Charlie, is that errant play where he ran into Rathman. They had to waste the down. Bo Schembechler, at this point, has a good opportunity to improve his bowl record.
And it needs all the help it can get. It's only, his record is 2-10.
He said he'd like to play a couple of doubleheaders.
That's right. While he's on a roll. He fires it. To the Fiesta Bowl. Here's a quote from Bo. If we win it, the players all realize it's in spite of the coaches, whatever it takes to win bowl games. I ain't got it. It's kind of an albatross around my neck, but it isn't going to make or break my career. I've already established I cannot win bowl games. Well, that's not entirely true. And here's Jamie Moore. It'll be no gain, so it'll be second down and 10, Mike Knox for the defense. You mentioned that he ought to go for the doubleheader. Well, we did a quick check of the record book, and he had a doubleheader in bowl games in 1981. How did he do that? Well, the Rose Bowl at the start of 81, and he won the Blue Bonnet Bowl at the end of 81. Just thought I'd mention that. I can tell how thrilled you are with that statement, Sam. His record, Bo's record is 2-10, not all that good.
The only one that matters is today.
That's true. That's true. Second down and 10. 7.5 minutes to go here in Fiesta Bowl 15. Harbaugh with a little play action, and he goes deep, and it is incomplete as he overthrows Paul Jokic.
Harbaugh's pass intended for number.
So it'll be third down and 10 back at the 19-yard line.
Incomplete.
It's a play action pass. The quarterback fakes to his backs to his right.
Third and 10 from.
And he comes back, rolling out to his left. Behind a good block by Mike Huser. Jovich is wide open. Danny Newton, number 95, knocks him to the ground, but the ball was overthrown.
We've talked about the Michigan defense. Well, that Nebraska defense did not give up a fourth quarter point in their last five games. Harbaugh has completed 6 of 15 for 63 yards, 1 of 3 in the second half. He scrambles for it and just kind of works his way back to the line of scrimmage, and that's about it. As Steve Forrest and Danny Noonan pitch down on it. So it will be fourth down. That means that Monty Robbins will be kicking, and Nebraska could have good field position. Rob Schnitzler and Brian Siebler are set for the return, and if they get any kind of return, they'll have the ball around the 50-yard line.
Nebraska right now can score a touchdown, be right back in the ball game, and the second touchdown that they score will be the go-ahead, and they could win this football game.
6:45 and counting, that is the time remaining. And they both talk to each other thinking, Schnitzler thought that Siebler was going to take it, and Siebler thought that Schnitzler was going to take it, and they were about the 38-yard line. That cost him 15 yards. The punt, 59 yards. Nebraska's the ball, but poor field position. All right, thank you, Dick Enberg. We've got a strange sight for you there. Happy feet, I guess that's what you would call it, and you got a happy feet at the Rose Bowl. Iowa and UCLA will be joining Dick and Merlin. As soon as the game is over here, they've got another good one for you. Then on to the Orange Bowl, the battle for number one, Penn State against Oklahoma. Steve Taylor, the ball carrier. And the 23 out to the 25, so it'll be second down and 8 as Mike Reinhold and Mark Mester make the stop.
Second and 8.
Here's Jim Harbaugh, the quarterback of Michigan, on the sideline. Scored 2 touchdowns in the second half. Quarterback draw, the last play, is not going to get it done. They've got to drop back and throw the football and get it upfield.
Pretty good move by Steve Taylor. He got his struggles to the 37-yard line, but he scrambles for 12, has the first down. Mallory and Mallory, Doug and Mike, the brothers. Brothers Mallory, make the stop.
At this point, it's important to throw the ball upfield to come up with big plays. Right now, the Nebraska offense is playing in the hands of the Michigan defense because they've got a two-score lead, 27-14, and the clock is running.
5:35 left to go in Fiesta Bowl 15. Here's pressure. The pass is tipped incomplete. A little too tall for Todd Frame. Meanwhile, Steve Taylor was being pressured by Mike Rhino, so he had to get rid of it. And it'll be second down and 10 at the Nebraska 37-yard line. Tony Gant had the coverage downfield.
Tough spot for a freshman quarterback, Steve Taylor. And the Michigan defense right now is not concerned about Nebraska's running game, and they're really turning everybody loose and put pressure on the quarterback.
And the give is to Doug DeBose. And DeBose goes to the 44. He picks up 7, Dieter Heron with the tackle. So it'll be third down and about 3 to go for the first down. Steve Taylor, during the regular season, threw only 6 passes, completed 3. And here he's completed 1 of 4.
Now, it's, as I said, Charlie, I don't mean to be redundant, but it's a very difficult situation for him to be in right now, and I'm sure that Coach Osborne is protecting him by running the football, because they're really coming defensively on the part of Michigan.
Here's DeBose. He may have the big play to the 40, to the 30, to the 25-yard line. Tony Gann and Garland Rivers save the touchdown, but 31 yards for Doug DeBose. And he stays down as the trainers are there. Now remember, he's playing with that shoulder injury that he suffered on Sunday.
Watch now. It's an option and a pitch to DeBose. He breaks back to the inside. He's looking for the big run. Almost makes it. And there's Tony Gant, number 14, makes the play. And DeBose looks like he's holding on to that shoulder, left shoulder that he hurt this week in practice.
So the ball at the 25-yard line, DeBose now, 17 carries for 100 yards.
He's averaged 116 in every game this year.
And it's a first down for Nebraska. Keith Jones is now the I-back. Pressure from behind, and the pass is complete. At the 18-yard line, Jim Scarcelli was chasing Steve Taylor, and he could hear him coming. Von Shepherd with the reception at the 18-yard line, gain of 7, second and 3.
I'll guarantee you Steve Taylor right now had a sixth sense about what was coming in behind him. Right now he gets rid of the ball. He knows he's going to get hit. Excellent catch on the part of Von Shepherd. And they're inside the 20. They've got to get on the board right now.
Second down and 3 at the 18-yard line. Into the end zone. Good defensive coverage, though. Perfect defensive coverage. Garland Rivers had excellent coverage on Rod Smith. Let's go down to Gary Gerald.
Charlie, yes, we got a quick word with the trainer. We understand it is that bruised shoulder that he suffered on Sunday. However, they expect that they will try to get him right back in the ballgame. And, of course, it's critical. Now they desperately need a touchdown.
With 3 minutes and 51 seconds, that's all the time remaining, Gary. Third down and 3 at the 18. Ken Kalen gets the call, and Mike Reinhold is there to meet him in the hole. A yard, if that. So it's going to be fourth down and 2.
And as they run the ball, they run the clock, and they're playing into Michigan's hands. Right now, that was a very conservative call, and I think the reason for it is that Tom Osborne is trying to take some pressure off that young quarterback, Steve Taylor. Very difficult for a head coach right now with a freshman quarterback in this situation.
They look for the run. They go with extra linebackers. The momentum is going to carry to the 13-yard line for Steve Taylor, and I think that's going to be enough. Steve Thiebert, the junior from Union Lake, Michigan, was there for the Wolverine defense along with Jim Scarcelli.
Pick up a 4-yard.
First down at the 13-yard line. We're moving on the 3-minute mark.
Now it's fourth down. He knows he has to get the first down, so run north and south. Don't go from sideline to sideline. I think this young man's going to be a fine quarterback. He's obviously an excellent athlete.
at the Michigan 13-yard line. Fake on the pitch out. He comes back. Throws behind, incomplete. Todd Frame had a step on Doug Mallory, but the pass was behind him. Second and 10 at the 13.
It's again another play action. Mike Hammerstein almost makes the play. Now he rears back and he throws behind Todd Frame. Had he hit Todd Frame with Doug Mallory in pursuit, he might have brought that football into the end zone.
Second and 10, and Doug DeBose comes back into the lineup for Nebraska. Taylor rolls left, has blockers in front, lots of time to throw, finds an opening. He gets to the one, and that's it. Brad Cochran met him maybe a foot shy of the goal line. And there's the clock, 2:37. Mike Mallory for the Michigan defense.
And Steve Taylor has a receiver wide open. But again, this looks like a maze to this young quarterback. And what he's going to do instinctively is tuck the ball and run. As he gets an opportunity to play and gains more confidence, he's going to see those open receivers. It's just a reaction by an inexperienced quarterback. He should have thrown it in the end zone to an open receiver.
And Michigan takes their last timeout, stopping the clock with 2:35 left to go. Michigan has the lead, but Nebraska threatens. 2 minutes and 35 seconds left to go in Fiesta Bowl 15. It's Michigan out in front of Nebraska, 27-14, but the Cornhuskers just a foot away. There you can see it.
Doug DeBose for a touchdown, and then line up for the onside kick.
They've got flags. The Nebraska has been fumbling, you know, in the second half. So I'm wondering here if they just want to go with Taylor in a quarterback sneak simply to get away from one exchange.
Well, they're fumbling, that's true, but I think they're going to hand the ball off to Doug DeBose and then line up and kick, hopefully, the onside kick and recover it.
Michigan is offside, so we'll split the difference, and it'll still be first down goal to go. It's going to be about, just about that far away.
Bo is saying, can't you let me relax in this bowl game? I was hoping I was going to win it going away. And right now, if Nebraska scores, and it looks like they're going to, they could get possession and have an opportunity to score another touchdown, kick the extra point, and win the game.
Quarterback sneak. With no sign. Touchdown, Nebraska. .229 left to go in the game. Nebraska driving 77 yards.
Dale Klein will attempt the extra point. Holding will be number 12.
27-20. And Dale Klein will attempt the extra point. Blakeman with the hold. It is good. And Nebraska pulls within 6 points of Michigan with 2:29 left. And we'll be back with the onside kick in just a moment. Don't go away. And let's take a look at the Nebraska touchdown.
Watch the snap. Goes right behind his center, Bill Lewis, and they're in for a touchdown. They've got 2 minutes and
29
seconds left to go. We'll probably have an onside kick. Michigan has nine men close to the 50-yard line. They've got their good hands people in there right now. If they can recover the kick, the game could be over. If Nebraska can recover the kick, they got a chance to win the game. And remember, Michigan went for 2 points. They made it with a throw in the end zone to Paul Jokic, and it was called back, and they kicked for the extra point. And right now, this score could be 28-21 instead of 27-21. And they decide to kick the ball deep.
I am surprised. Jamie Morris at the one. So Nebraska relying on their defense. He's cut down at the 10. Klein, the kicker, who makes the play.
And right now, you can see by the way the Nebraska defense has played all game long that Tom Osborne has a tremendous amount of confidence in his defense. And remember, in the third quarter, it was not the Nebraska defense, it was the Nebraska offense that gave up all those points. And now the ball is inside the 10-yard line. And is this a big series for the Michigan offense?
Number three for Nebraska on the coverage team was Gary Schneider. So now it must be the defense of Nebraska. Michigan does not have a timeout. Nebraska has two timeouts remaining. Gerald White. Brian Davis
ball
for the
Huskers. 22, Gerald White.
A gain of three from the 9 to the 12. Second down and 7.
Pick up a few yards on the play.
Right now, Michigan needs to hold on to the ball, get Nebraska to use those timeouts, and knock out two first downs, and they have this game won.
Nebraska needs one more possession. Second down and 7. Gerald White's a tailback. Perryman's a fullback. And it's White. And he is hit at the line of scrimmage. And a flag is down. Maybe a delay of game. 25 seconds. They may have taken too long. Chris Spachman and Kevin Parsons were there for the Huskers. The clock says 1 minute and 40 seconds left, and the scoreboard reads Michigan 27, Nebraska 21.
And remember that two-point play in the end zone where Michigan right now could have a 28-21 lead.
At halftime, Nebraska led 14-3. And then it was Michigan in the third quarter leading 27-14. Now it's 27-21.
And Michigan has no timeouts, and Nebraska has two valuable timeouts. You think Bo's worried about his bowl record right now? This thing is going right down to the wire.
Second down and 12. The ball at the 7-yard line. 1:45. Time remaining. The running backs are now Jamie Morris, the tailback, and Gerald White, the fullback. The Nebraska band. And Jamie Morris has rushed for 156 yards and 21 carries. The quarterback is Jim Harbaugh. He scored 2 touchdowns for the Wolverines.
Clay Miller offside.
Going to be against Michigan.
That illegal procedure. Clay Miller jumped offside. Their left tackle. There's Bo Schembechler. The thing that he's worried about right now is punter is going to have to kick the ball from the end line, which means that Nebraska is going to get an opportunity for run back and certainly good field position.
Now there's another possibility. A safety, 2 points. Now that changes the complexion.
Right now, I think that Michigan can run the ball 2 downs and get involved in using Nebraska's timeouts, and they may very well take a safety so that they can get decent field position.
Second and 50, the ball back at the 3-yard line. Now it's going to be back at the 2-yard line. But the clock ticks. 138, 137, 136, they stop it there.
And Nebraska just lost 8 to 10 valuable seconds.
Tony Holloway making the last play with the Huskers. And Nebraska will now have one timeout remaining. Michigan does not have any timeouts remaining.
Right now, Charlie, on third down, they can get Nebraska to take that final timeout. And then on fourth down, have the quarterback take a safety. That means there'll be 4 points up. Nebraska still has to kick, score a touchdown to win. And I think that would be good strategy on the part of Schembechler right now. And I'm sure that's what he talked over with his quarterback.
Don't forget, coming up next, the Rose Bowl. Iowa and UCLA. Dick Enberg, Merlin Olsen, Bill McAtee, they're all set in Pasadena. And then they'll be passing the banner right to the Orange Bowl, the battle for number one. Penn State against Oklahoma, Don Cricky, Bob Trumpy, Bob Greasy, and Jimmy Cefalo all there for the coverage. So once again, Happy New Year, everybody, and thanks for starting 1986 like you did 1985 if you're with us for the Fiesta, the Rose, and the Orange. And it seems as the Fiesta Bowl always comes down to the wire.
What I would do right now, I wouldn't take any chance. I would run a quarterback sneak and then come back with the safety. Because right now, a fumble means they lose the game. There is absolutely no reason to take that chance.
So you want the quarterback sneak, then force Nebraska to take their last time out, then take the safety, and then punt from the 20.
Then punt from the 20, and Nebraska now has a freshman quarterback in with no timeouts.
And they don't have a passing game. Okay, let's see what happens. A possibility as the finale unrolls. And there's the quarterback sneak. There's part one of the Reticliano story. I think you may be right, Sam. And now Nebraska takes a timeout. That's part two. So Nebraska's out of timeouts. Minute 29. That is the time remaining.
Now take the safety. I'll be very surprised if they punt this football.
When play resumes, the ball will be at the 4-yard line. It will be fourth down and 15.
Field goal means nothing to Nebraska, because if you kick a field goal, you can't go for two.
It's Michigan 27, Nebraska 21. The way the scoring unfolded, Michigan started with a 42-yard field goal by Moons, and then Nebraska came back on a touchdown pass, of all things. It was Clayton to DuBose. DuBose then scored from 3 yards out. For Michigan, White from a yard out. Harbaugh scored from a yard out. Moons with a 19-yard field goal. Harbaugh with his second touchdown. For Nebraska, Taylor from a foot away. That's a fast rundown, and probably only those that closely follow Michigan and Nebraska will understand what I just said.
Bo Schembechler just had the entire team on the sideline, and I'm sure right now that the punter is going to feel the ball, wait for the rush, and step out of the end line, and then come back.
Because one of the things he wants to do is run some time off the clock. Let's see what he does. You're exactly right. That's what he's going to do, but they got to chase him. He'll stay back there. He's running time off. Then he steps away, and he ran it down to 122. Good call, Sam. 2 points to Nebraska, and it's 27-23, and he ran off 17 seconds. And NBC Sports would like to send our special thanks to Fiesta Bowl 15 President Tom Nix, Executive Director Bruce Skinner, Associate Executive Director John Junker, Arizona State Associate Athletic Director, Gold Medalist Herman Frazier, Tom Fredina, Dewey Shade, and all the folks who worked so very hard to make this Fiesta Bowl 15 such a major success. 27-23, and it's not over yet. We're out of timeouts, and we have 1:22 left to go. Good call, Sam.
That's why I'm up in the booth right now, Kelly.
With the safety, 27-23, the margin is 4. What it means is, it's just as it was before, it means Nebraska has to score a touchdown to win, but this way, you're not kicking with your back to the wall, you're giving your punter some leeway.
You're fighting for a field position, because a 4-point or 6-point lead doesn't mean anything. Nebraska still has to score a touchdown.
Rob Schnitzler and Von Shepherd are the two return men for Tom Osborne, the head coach of the Cornhuskers. Boy, what a record. He's only been a head coach at Nebraska, and what a great job that he has done there.
He was handpicked by Bob Devaney and has done an outstanding job. And there's Gary Moeller right now. He is really upset. He's trying to tell him what to do. What he's trying to do right now is to tell the punter to put the ball in either corner. Do not kick the ball straight down the field. And he kicks it straight down the field.
Monty Robbins, a kicker, but it's a good one. Shepherd takes it back at the 16-yard line. He needs a big return. He may have it. It's to the 40, and he goes out of bounds at the 45-yard line. Stopping the clock with 1:14. Greg Randall was there, a 64-yard punt, but a good return for Shepard at 29 yards.
And he had presence of mind to get out of bounds because Nebraska does not have any timeouts left. And right now they have to go to a no-huddle offense. They've got to throw to get the ball upfield and make sure that their receivers get out of bounds to stop that clock. The biggest thing right now for Nebraska is to get the ball upfield and stop the clock.
1:14 left to go. Taylor. He's got to get to the sideline to stop the clock. They say no. He went down and then slid out. So the clock is moving. At the 49-yard line of Michigan, Doug Mallory took him out.
And that's
56 seconds and counting. Costly play.
And that's what an inexperienced quarterback will do. He should have come back in a play-action pass. If he didn't have anybody open, just throw the ball and stop the clock.
Incomplete at the 45-yard line. Shepard, the intended receiver, Mike Mallory, was there for the defense. Stopping the clock, 39 seconds. It was Doug Mallory who was there. So it's going to be third down and five at the 49.
They got to take a shot and throw the ball deep and hope for a big play or the possibility of a pass interference. Because this young quarterback right now, that defense looks like Times Square on New Year's Eve.
And of course in college ball, the pass interference is only going to be 15 yards.
But they'll have an opportunity to move the ball upfield and stop the clock.
The inability of Taylor to get out of bounds of play before the last cost Nebraska 27 seconds. There's a delayed play action. Got the throw. Unleash it. Goes he. Boy, what an arm. He overthrows it. Intercepted in the end zone. Garland Rivers has the interception. Turnover of the ball game, 28 seconds left to go, and all that Michigan needs to do is run out the clock. And the safety man is Paul Jokic behind our, and Jokic puts the bear hug on him. He's 6'8", 240-pound senior, and now they can take the full countdown. It's been a good one. Michigan had to come from behind. They trail at halftime 14-3, and Michigan is going to win it 27-23, and credit the Michigan defense in the third quarter.
And Bo Schembechler has improved his bowl record.
There it is, the final countdown. Once again, it has been a great Fiesta Bowl. For Sam Ratigliano and Gary Gerald, I'm Charlie Jones. The final, Michigan 27, Nebraska 23. Now let's go to the Rose Bowl. Dick Enberg and Merlin Olsen.